Fessiara, right now showing you images. Yeah, you're right. Coming out of Tyrone, Georgia, microburst actually destroys 20 mobile homes. This is in the Atlanta area.
Screens out?
Yeah, just came down on that mobile home there. National Weather Service reporting microburst in Tyrone. About 80 mile per hour winds, 90 mile per hour winds knocked down these trees and power lines yesterday. As I said, nearly a dozen or more actually destroyed.
You can see this on radar. Okay, the thunderstorms actually formed off to the east earlier, and they sent out this huge outflow boundary.
Wow.
That didn't do much except cool them off. But then the storms came in. So underneath the storm, I mean, literally, the whole storm just collapsed right over
Tyrone. They were loud. They were loud. Just booming yesterday. All right, welcome back to AMHQ. Good morning. 29 minutes past the hour. Jim's in. Jen's in. Hi, I'm Sam. Ari's in for A-Rod this morning. And we're all here to make sure you get everything you need to look out the door before you head out the door. So let's say hello, America. Good morning to Louisville.
Good morning, Louisville. Right now, you're looking at cloudy skies out there.
Look at that.
Yeah, today you're going to see a few spotty thunderstorms out there. You're going to be in the 80s by the time you drive home, 91 degrees. Your high today, 93.
We got to pause here. Can you get the radar up? Because they're just about to get crushed in Louisville.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, Catherine, pump that.
You can see it.
In
look at that.
Yep. She says, give her a second and she will load that radar.
Okay, so we'll go on to the other stuff, but get ready, Louisville.
Go ahead.
It's coming in.
She's coming with it. There it is right there.
See, and why I wanted to bring that up too, because there's a warning off to the cell to the north.
Yeah.
It's still about an hour away or so, but we got to watch that for some wind damage.
Yeah.
All right.
All right.
We're looking out for you, Louisville.
Thank you, guys.
Good morning, P. Cola. We'll show you what's going on the beach on the Gulf Coast this morning. Cloudy morning for you. We do have some scattered showers in the Pensacola area this afternoon. And I'll tell you, you'll be glad. Panama City, Pensacola, any of those areas that'll pick up the thunderstorms this afternoon, you're going to be glad. Because that'll at least break some of that heat and humidity that you'll be building during the afternoon hours. We're going to get to 86. It's going to feel just like a sweltering. You're going to need to stand in that water.
They'll be inland.
Absolutely.
So you'll be lay on the beach and watch them inland, unless there's lightning coming.
Yep. Now, for breakfast, check out the Egg and I on Davis Highway. One online review calls the Wisconsin Scramble a cheese lover's dream, ladies and gentlemen. Cheese lover's dream.
In Wisconsin.
Yeah. It's got Swiss, Jack, cheddar, and cream cheese, topped with a few onions, served with grits. Just walk in and say, a cheese lover's dream, please. It's the Egg and I on Davis
Highway. And then ask them to add feta. When you go, since there's enough cheese in there, ask him to add the feta.
Because four kinds of cheese isn't enough for Jim Cantore.
No. Yeah, you need five just to round it all out for you. That's right. Well, let's show you for today, the big picture. We have a lot going on today. We have severe weather that we're talking about. We have some Torcons today. They're at 3. And some of these big cities are going to be coming into play. As we show you the forecast for today, it's going to be right in the midsection of the country. We're going to see from the Central Plains, even over towards parts of the Mid-Atlantic, right along this boundary system. And what we're going to be looking at some of the stronger winds out there, and also going to be looking at more of that heavy rainfall potential out there. Could be looking at some problems with some flooding as we're going to be looking at these storms potentially starting to do some of that training out there. And then we look across parts of the southern areas, and once again it is going to be smoking hot out there. Temperatures are going to feel like the 100 degree mark for many areas. As we show you, we're going to be climbing with the actual temperatures very close to the 100 degree for Kansas City, Memphis, as well as Atlanta. You're all going to stay steamy out there, jet stream all the way up towards the north. Not being your friend today, but it is going to bring you some cooler weather as we head into the weekend. We'll talk more about that. But over towards the west, as we're going to be looking at a cool down for the east, things go up in the west. This ridge is building, and that means dangerous heat waves setting up for areas, including parts of Oregon, as well as into Washington, Idaho. And this is not going to be a short-term warm. We're going to be talking about this through at least next Friday with temperatures in the triple digits out there. So everybody, please be aware.
Heads up. We've been talking about it for a couple of days now, just to get you warned. All right, time to check out this hour's top news stories with Ari Sarsalari. Good morning, Ari.
Hey, good morning, Sam. Let's get you started off with some of your headlines. We're talking about 300 wildfires that are currently burning across Alaska. Yeah, one state, 300 wildfires. Of course, these fires follow record heat during May that fueled an early snowmelt. Now, the largest of those wildfires has burned almost 20,000 acres and 6 homes. All right, so President Obama, he's starting to lose his patience with some of these hecklers, especially those who interrupt him at White House events. Listen to this.
No. Hey. Yeah, listen, you're in my house. you're not going to get a good response from me by interrupting me like this.
I like it. Good style there.
Yeah.
Yeah, good stuff. All right, hey, so the president requested security to escort that guy out, and of course, that was the end of that, Sam.
Well, you know, that's not the way you get your point across anyway.
No,
heckling anybody. I don't care which side of the aisle you're on.
Totally agree.
Heckling someone is not the way to get
Come
your point
now.
Across. We can all be more polite. We can agree. We can disagree. You don't have to shout. What? Is someone telling me we're over? What? What? Are you shouting?
You ever feel like you're spinning? Like you're stuck in the same place in life? Just going round and round and round? Yeah, man. Been there.
No, actually spinning.
Oh, we can fix that by going to Midas. They have a great selection of tires. Sorry, Doug, I thought you were trying to get deep.
It's time to take a closer look at your tires. Get up to $140 back by mail on a set of four Goodyear, Cooper, and other select brands. Tires, brakes, oil, everything. Trust the Midas touch.
If you have moderate to severe plaque psoriasis, isn't it time to let the real you shine through? Introducing Otezla, apremilast. Otezla is not an injection or a cream. It's a pill that treats plaque psoriasis differently. Some people who took Otezla saw 75% clearer skin after 4 months. And Otezla's prescribing information has no requirement for routine lab monitoring. Don't take Otezla if you are allergic to any of its ingredients. Otezla may increase the risk of depression. Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Side effects may include diarrhea, nausea, upper respiratory tract infection, and headache. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you're pregnant or planning to be. Ask your doctor about Otezla today. Otezla. Show more of you.
What are you doing?
I'm having a small snack.
What?
Have you tried this mayonnaise? It's great.
Gross.
Don't live with ants. Get Raid Ant and Roach Spray.
Raid?
And take back your home. Raid kills bugs dead.
S.C. Johnson, a family company.
Every backyard comes together around a grill and Kingsford charcoal. Gather round.
Hurry into Lowe's and find big summer savings for this 4th of July, like 25% off select patio collections. Plus, get a $100 gift card on all Charbroil grill purchases, $3.29 and more via mail-in rebate. Don't miss out on summer's best savings at Lowe's.
Working on my feet all day gave me pain here
in my lower back.
But now I step on this machine and get my number, which matches my Dr. Scholl's custom fit orthotic inserts. Now I get immediate relief from my foot pain.
My lower back pain. Find a machine at drscholls.com.
Oh, man. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You're covered, Harry.
Oh, man.
You gotta do it like this. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Hey, George.
Hey, Jim.
Amateurs. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Hi, Travis.
Well, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
I'm here for you, Lonnie.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
This is a new one.
State Farm agents are there whenever you need them.
New episodes of Fat Guys in the Woods, Sundays at 9 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies early, then partly cloudy this afternoon. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Tonight, partly cloudy skies. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
39 minutes after the hour. Glad you're with us right here on AMHQ this morning. A live look at Portland, Oregon, home of the Portland Timbers Soccer Club. High in the low 90s today. You'll get even closer to 100 tomorrow, so take it easy. Could crack some triple digits on Saturday again. The athletes are sweating it out in summer training camps this week, and it doesn't really matter. You can be in a camp, you can be just playing a pickup game, and it's soccer, it's football, it's baseball, it's basketball, it's anything you're doing outside. It's a unique Weather Channel experiment. Meteorologist Paul Goodloe looks at how quickly the body can heat up and the best ways to bring your temperature back down.
How does the body react when it's under extra stress from scorching heat? We recruited James and Maddie, two Georgia Gwinnett college soccer players, to help us get the answer. For accurate core temperature readings, we asked them to really be team players by ingesting these sensors.
Essentially, this sensor, when swallowed, will lodge itself in the athlete's digestive tract, and that allows us to follow the athlete's temperature across the practice. So we can read the athlete's temperature on this data recorder in real time as the athlete is practicing.
That's a big one.
And that nice.
This information is crucial. It can help prevent problems like heat stroke. Before James hits the field, his body temperature is 98.5. Maddie, at 99.9. The temperature on the field, near 90 degrees, but the turf, which traps the heat, is a sweltering 130. Just 10 minutes into the warm-up drills and the body temperature already rising. James, now 99.4, Maddie, has warmed to 100.5. And after the warm-up, the real work begins. 25 minutes into the workout, and things are sizzling. James' core temperature spiking to 100.74, and Maddie up to 101.9, just a few degrees away from the danger zone.
104 is kind of the danger point.
After a grueling workout, we want to find the best way to bring the body core temperature back down. We started with a combination most of us would do, a cold drink in the air conditioning. After 10 minutes of this, Maddie's core temperature drops to 99.9. And now we're really cooling things down by asking James to take a dip in this ice bath.
The ice bath will quickly cool down an athlete, particularly if he's experiencing a heat illness.
After resting in this 44-degree water for 10 minutes, James' core temperature sinks to 100 degrees. Studies find athletes who know their limits and take time to cool down during and after a workout consistently perform better, which could mean the difference between winning and losing. I'm meteorologist Paul Goodloe.
That was so cool. All right, and just to say that the United States women's national team is in action tomorrow night in soccer, since we're staying there. The knockout stage of the World Cup is. They'll face China in Ottawa, and here's the forecast for that. So these temperatures are perfect. No worries about heat there. 71 degrees in the evening hours. Then we go into the nighttime game, and we're staying in the 60s in Canada. Fascinating stuff. I'm still just wowed over that Paul Goodloe piece. The record heat in the West and the cool down coming on in the East, it's doing this. So we want you to know how these changes are happening over time, and it's only something you're going to get all in one place right here at the Weather Channel with Jim and Jen.
Yeah, that's right. We're still in awe too, Sam, about that ingesting a thermometer.
Yeah, I mean, can you imagine?
I'm just like, wow.
Sometimes you do those things, right?
Exactly.
All right, we're talking about meteorograms today.
We are. Meteorograms are great because as meteorologists, we can look at things, we can look at multiple things, do some overlays and trends as well, which really this is basically the way now we look at forecasts, not only on the internet,
on our phones,
but also
like
on
you
our
were
phones.
Saying. Yeah, absolutely.
Exactly. So let's take two cities. We're going to take Charlotte and also into Boise. First, a 24-hour meteorogram and then a 5-day meteogram. Go ahead, Jen.
Yeah, we're looking at the 24-hour one. And for today, we know the temperatures are going to be hot today. 97 degrees, 4 o'clock. But what we want to show you, look at those warm winds coming in from the south. And that's why you're looking at those temperatures being just so hot
today.
Yes,
let's tell everybody. Sky cover, temperature, trend.
And chances of rain.
Chances of precipitation, which are maximized in the afternoon. Not very high, by the way. And then not only are you getting wind direction with the barb, but also the speed of the wind, which will go up in the barb. So really cool stuff. So now let's go on in time and see what's going to happen with Charlotte in terms of the trend. So you can see the daily highs and lows that we get when the sun comes up, the sun goes down. But the trend is for cooler temperatures and
some rain. for Saturday.
Exactly.
But if you notice that we're also going to look at those rain chances really peaking up here. See that coming up there. That's Saturday. And then we head to Sunday. We dry things off. But at least you're back into the 80s, back to more normal conditions. But where we're not going to see the normal weather is going to be in Boise. We'll probably talk more about that coming up.
Big heat today. Show a quick 5-day here, guys. I got to show this because it's too good.
I mean, look at this.
We're talking about 109 on Sunday, by the way. That would tie the all-time record high for the month of June in Boise.
Even sticking around through next Friday. We'll be right back here at AMHQ.
Are you road ready? Underinflation gives tires better traction in warmer weather. True or false?
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tires she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even as it wears down over time, its safety doesn't, thanks to Evergrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn.
B, false. No matter the season, your tire's worst enemy is underinflation.
Hurry into Lowe's and find big summer savings for this 4th of July. Like $10 off our best interior paint and primer in one, and up to $25 off all resurfacers. Plus, get 20% off all in-stock level or faux wood blinds.
Seal cracks and splinters with the ultimate do-over for wood and concrete. Don't replace, resurface. Behr Premium Decover, exclusively at the Home Depot.
Introducing the first ever gummy multivitamin from Centrum. A complete and tasty new way to support your energy, immunity, and metabolism like never before. Centrum Multigummies. See gummies in a whole new light.
A witness when you set the world in motion. The Ram ProMaster van. And introducing the all-new Ram ProMaster City. Purpose-built to help you run the town. Ram.
At Alpacher Lincoln, we want you to have luxury for less this summer. That's why we offer the best savings and selection. Savings, like a 2015 Lincoln MKX, just $389 a month. Or a 2015 Lincoln Navigator, just $599 a month. Savings, with bottom line windshield pricing. Selection, over 200 new Lincolns to choose from. Only at Alpacher Lincoln on Military Trail. And remember,
before you buy, price pack.
Watch the hottest new movies with Xfinity.
We met this interesting couple.
What's the rumpish, rednecks?
I love his shoes. I have some wingtips here somewhere. Stop wearing them when I got shin splints.
You have arthritis in your knee.
Arthritis? Arthritis?
I usually just say it once.
Ow! I've learned you can discover more by allowing yourself to be surprised.
Ah! Josh, you're hysterical.
I'm not hysterical!
Own or rent while we're young by visiting the movies section. Instantly access your favorites with Xfinity On Demand.
In a matter of seconds, your life can change.
We're kids still in school.
And it just hit us.
This was it. The Weather Channel's most watched original program is back.
Things were just going everywhere.
It was a nightmare.
And then it was silent.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies early, then partly cloudy this afternoon. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Tonight, partly cloudy skies. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
All right, severe thunderstorms expected once again today along the I-25 from Denver on north. A little different than yesterday, though. They will move off to the southeast. And as you can see, they weren't moving much at all here. So they unloaded their hail core over Denver yesterday as the storms moved off to the east. Some awesome-looking storms structurally. If you're out there chasing, obviously, you got some great, great pictures yesterday. And today will be another opportunity to do that. As a matter of fact, SPC added a 2% tornado probability to southeast Wyoming and eastern Colorado. So keep that in mind as well. So there'll be a chance for some rotating storms there that may produce tornadoes. All right, so this morning we're watching this one area, kind of leading edge of some stronger winds actually beginning to move its way now north of Louisville on over towards Cincinnati. And it'll continue to move down through Lexington, across I-75, through Maysville as well. And some of these storms look kind of interesting. We need to keep an eye on these. There's some notches on the leading edge of this bow, and sometimes you get a little spin up there in some of these notches here. So let's just keep an eye on some of these as they continue to roll into these. Cincinnati, we mentioned it's already raining there. Let's take a look at the cameras out of Cincinnati, Ohio this morning. And there you can see wet roads. That's probably I-75. I wouldn't be surprised if it was. It is I-75. Okay. So there you go. Wet roads as you're heading in and out of Cincinnati. Again, the biggest threat looks like it's going to pass just to your south in terms of what we have going on currently. More storms may return this afternoon, but really that whole pocket is just going to work its way across West Virginia and down into eastern Virginia and eastern North Carolina today. And with it, there may even be some severe weather. Let's talk about this. This is really a spot I want you to watch today. Here's the high-resolution model, the 930 update. So remember, these update very, very often. They're only 15 hours long. There's a tremendous amount of data that goes into some of these high-resolution models, and sometimes they're good, sometimes they're awful, but I kind of like what they're doing today because there's a lot of instability here. The front's here. The atmospheric suggests damaging wind. So look at what happens as we go beyond 5 o'clock this afternoon. And we talked about this earlier. Big squall line coming off the mountains of the river. It's already storming from Washington down through Fredericksburg. But eventually this kind of gels and starts to show signatures of damaging wind. All right, so we may see a damaging wind threat work its way not too far north, really, of Raleigh, or possibly into Raleigh, through Richmond, Norfolk, the Tidewater area of the Chesapeake Bay, as we go through the evening. So this will be post to sundown here, working its way off to the southeast. And then some of the models actually just keep this here and produce a heavy rain event. So let's watch out for that. All right, next spot we're going to go is out here. We talked about this severe potential from Denver on up towards Cheyenne and in toward Casper. This is kind of the tail end of the front, if you will, and the jet streams from the northwest moving to the southeast. Here's what's happening now. Not much. A few little poppers here on the front through Kansas and Colorado, which the models don't do well in initializing, but I like what they do certainly in the afternoon because we know there's going to be storms that'll develop over the front range and they will push off to the southeast, including Denver, a possibility in through here. And some of these, because of the wind today, Sam, and the upper levels of the atmosphere, may actually produce some damage as well. So damaging wind, a big threat today, whether you be in Virginia, North Carolina, or in Wyoming or Colorado. Back to you.
All right, Jim. Ari has all the social images being shared today. Let's go.
We had a really big supercell out in Iowa. It was right around dusk, maybe just before is when it started, and really it created a lot of severe, weather in that area. Okay, of course, we had some tree damage. There was a lot of this kind of stuff, power lines down. Had a couple reports of funnel clouds, even one report, at least, of a tornado. I'm sure the Weather Service will be surveying that today. But the cool thing about this was when you looked at this storm on visible satellite, okay, just look how fast it went up. It is just absolutely nuts. Watch just west of Des Moines, okay?
Oh, there it is.
Boom.
Oh, there it is.
Yep. And then if you look on the east side of the storm, you can actually see, and you've got to look a little bit closely as you get closer to dusk, but you know the sun's on the west side here, so it's actually casting a shadow of the big anvil cloud down on the ground. So that's pretty interesting stuff. The thing that Catherine is circling there, those are overshooting tops, okay? And this is all gonna tie in, don't worry. We got another social picture coming up here in just a second, but check that out. Those are the tops of the updrafts, okay? So
that punch through, because they're moving so fast, they punch through the normal cloud of the top.
Yeah, right. And a lot of the times on supercells, you get those things. Check out this picture, okay? This was somebody who took a picture of the storm from really far away, and I don't know the exact location. He said this was a supercell over Iowa. I'm gonna kind of eyeball that, say maybe 60, 70 miles away. But look at that. You can actually see those overshooting tops from that far away.
When you're flying in a plane and you see all of a sudden just that big towering white cloud that comes up, now you'll be able to jostle the person next to you and go, oh, that's an overshooting top.
If you should be so lucky to get a view like that. Stu Ostro always does, it seems like. Lucky guy.
Awesome pictures. Thank you. Hey, everybody, we're celebrating our country's small towns and communities. And one of our semifinalists for the America's Best Communities competition is Susanville in northeastern California. Susanville was named, by the way, in 1857 after Susan Roop, daughter of an early settler. I knew them. They were lovely people. Isaac Roop. People love it for its rural atmosphere and easy access to outdoor recreation. It's one of the reasons why I'm there every chance I can get. Susanville, sunny skies today, Saturday, 100 degrees.
It may seem strange, but people really can love their laxative, especially when it's Miralax. It hydrates, eases, and softens to unblock your system naturally, so you have peace of mind from start to finish. Love your laxative, Miralax.
Every backyard comes together around a grill and Kingsford charcoal. Gather round.
What do you think of when you think of the United States Postal Service?
Exactly. That's what pushes us to deliver smarter.
Simpler.
Faster. Sleeker. Earlier.
Fresher.
Harder. Farther. Quicker. And yeah, even on Sundays.
What's next? We'll show you.
Let's do this. Don't think it's possible? Think again. With the summer's best savings, the upgrades are better than ever. So let's go for the bells and the whistles. Bridges that open like this. And whoa, did you see that? It's time to reset our expectations. Right now, it's all within reach. Let's do this. Get a Samsung washer, dryer, or fridge, each just $9.98. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
So we've had a Tempur-Pedic for a while, but now that we have the adjustable base, it's even better.
When I put my feet up on this bed, my stress just goes away.
Our Tempur-Pedic is the best thing in our house, except for my husband.
Wait, where are you going?
Visit your local retailer and discover how Tempur-Pedic can move you.
Bill, have you seen my keys anywhere?
I'll help you look.
Maybe you left them in the bathroom again.
Warning signs of Alzheimer's disease may be right in front of you.
It's all right, baby.
For help and information, call the Alzheimer's Association or visit alz.org/10signs.
Get fast-acting, long-lasting relief from heartburn with doctor-recommended Gaviscon. It neutralizes stomach acid and is the only product that forms a protective barrier that helps keep stomach acid in the stomach where it belongs. For fast-acting, long-lasting relief, try Gaviscon.
This is good, Mom.
Good? It's delicious. And this new kibble blend is so healthy.
Thank you.
No, Nancy. Thank you. Kibbles and bits, because every bit matters.
New episodes of Fat Guys in the Woods, Sundays at 9 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies early, then partly cloudy this afternoon. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Tonight, partly cloudy skies. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Top of the hour, AMHQ right here. Hey, Thursday's got a move on it, so very soon it's Friday. Let's make this amazing. Severe shot. This picture taken just minutes ago. A shelf cloud looming over Odin, Indiana, 2 hours southwest of Indianapolis. We've got a severe threat today. Heavy rain, flash flooding, isolated tornadoes from the Mississippi Valley to the Mid-Atlantic. We've been watching this develop live. We've got new stuff for you on it this morning. Double trouble for Denver. Flooding and hammering hail from 2+ inches of rain yesterday in less than 30 minutes, and you could get another band of it today, so we'll talk about that. Scorching wildfires in California and nearly 300 active fires burning in Alaska right now. This is Santa Clarita, north of LA, 360 acres charred. It's the latest in the fight against the fires. We've got it for you as mandatory evacuation is lifted in that area. But first, Jim, this line of severe storms, remember when we caught that picture outside of Louisville, watching it work to the north of that area?
Yeah, and now that's all going to just come to the east today. We're going to see new storms build over West Virginia. Really worried about Virginia and northern North Carolina here. Could be damaging wind threat here as we go through the afternoon. Also, eastern Colorado, eastern Wyoming, you're in this as well. So a long area. We're going to have a couple of days of this, and then by Saturday, all this moves back toward the Mid-Atlantic. Our torcons aren't super high today. Three out of 10 chance of a tornado, but that's not zero. And remember that, okay? We've seen some changes in the drought monitor during this hour. We will tell you about where they are.
All right.
So stick around.
All right. And if that rain in the Northeast stays around, there could be some changes next week as well.
Thumbs up, yeah.
All right. Okay, Jim. Some of the heaviest rain this morning moving through Illinois, Indiana, also Western Ohio. You've been getting some. A live look at Indianapolis and Cincinnati for you this morning. Indy, we're getting hit right now. Cincinnati, things are starting to pick up for us in the Cincy area. So Illinois, under flash flood warnings this morning, particularly Central Illinois, runs right through the middle of Indiana as well, into that portion of Western Ohio where all the rain's been falling. Our Mike Seidel is live in Peoria. Mike has been on the northern line of this rain all morning long, and now it's moved well to his south. Good morning, Mike.
Good morning, Sim. Yes, the rain has ended. We picked up 1.18 inches since dinner time last night. The heaviest rain fell overnight, a little lightning and thunder, 0.42 in 1 hour. So you can imagine when you spread it out over about a 12 to 14 hour period, you're not going to get flash flooding. We didn't have any here. What you're seeing is river flooding. The river has slowly come up. This is the Peoria River. It's come over the wall here down at the beautiful Riverwalk Park. They're pumping water. They've got sandbags as far as the eye can see to keep the water at least into the grassy area and into the streets. But again, no homes are impacted, no businesses at this point. It's at 26.3 feet, flood stage 18. The moderate flood stage expected to crest at 27.3, slowly rising another foot by Sunday, and then starting to slowly back off based on the current forecast and the lack of rainfall going into next week with the pattern change, the lack of severe weather. Remember, they've had all these MCSs, and we had the rain from Bill. Take a look at the rain we ran into yesterday. Coming down Interstate 55, we got hammered with a downpour. Then the sun came out, and we were treated to a beautiful rainbow. In fact, this strong as I've ever seen a rainbow at the base, and we even got a portion of a secondary rainbow here. This is just north of Bloomington, Illinois. And the rainfall continues to back away, Sam. We could have some thunderstorms this afternoon. That severe threat, as Jim mentioned, but the weekend and into next week looks scrumptious with temperatures 75 to 80, plenty of sunshine, severe threat goes away, and none of that 90-degree heat and humidity. Sam?
All right, Mike, taking a look at the river flooding right there along the Peoria River, but I'll tell you what's lighting up right now. That's Ohio, also northern Kentucky. So from Cincinnati, even toward Lexington, Jim, that's getting a little bit of a punch right now.
That spot, and that's the spot we could certainly see some damaging winds, even already this morning. Doesn't really matter the time of the day. In this case, there's so much instability already existing. The storms are ongoing. They can just press on through. It's easy to get a 60-mile-an-hour wind gust when you have a monster like this. Big thunderstorm complex. It's kind of interesting. Well, the main complex started back here across Iowa, Missouri. We had heavy rain last night in some areas. We measured about 7 inches of rain. That's weakened a little bit and pushed to the south across northern Missouri. But a new one has kind of taken over here on the east side. And this really may be the game of the day here as we watch it move across Kentucky, West Virginia, and Virginia. And that's what I think the HER model is hinting at for us this afternoon with our damaging wind threat. Look at this. This is pretty- pretty cool looking at the rainfall, what happened over the last 12 hours. Some very heavy rain to the south of the Des Moines area in the town called Indianola. They actually had to do evacuations there. Then you overlay that with what happened over the last 36 hours, and we weren't too far off from seeing a repeat heavy rain event over some of the same areas. As a matter of fact, some of the model estimates are about a foot of rain just to the west of Des Moines here. So we have, ladies and gentlemen, some wet cornfields this morning. And here's what Sam was talking about. Cincinnati again down toward Lexington and Louisville. This little triangle definitely dealing with some very, very heavy rain, not to mention some chances for some gusty winds in through here. The Storm Prediction Center did put out a discussion on this, but they're saying the chances of a watch are pretty low. Either way, there's still a damaging wind threat, whether they put out a watch or not. Let's take a look at Cincinnati. That's the only camera I want to look at here. Again, the main lightning threat off toward the south, but a wet drive for you. If you are heading up out of Lexington on I-75, you will run into that rain in Kentucky well before you get to Cincinnati. And if you wait a little bit longer, you're going to run into some very, very heavy rain, not to mention a tremendous light show. So here's the radar this morning. This is the game for the east, I think. Watching it and modeling it out, it's going to work its way across Ohio, across parts of West Virginia. Look at this. By 1:30, the model already suggests that we've got a big bow here that we're watching with a damaging wind threat. That dissolves itself over the Appalachians, but that doesn't mean it's gone. By 6 o'clock tonight, it reappears and potentially produces damaging wind all the way from the Chesapeake Bay down and through the Tidewater and even as far south as Raleigh in North Carolina. So some active times ahead. Let's talk about this southeast heat and eventual cool down. We got a couple of days, but it will cool down in the southeast, won't it, Jen?
Yeah, and you know what, Jim? We actually need that cool down in a big way because we have been suffering with temperatures in the upper 90s as well as into the triple digits over the last several days. Really, in some of these areas, almost 10 days. As we show you for Nashville, we are starting off the day really warm and humid out there already. By 11 o'clock, it's going to feel like 94 degrees. Let's show you from 1 o'clock all the way through about 8 o'clock tonight. You're going to be looking at heat index values, what it's going to feel like near 100 degrees. So your body, it's not going to be able to cool off. You want to go for a walk, you're going to have to wait until almost 10 o'clock, and even still then, it's going to be hot. Showing you what's happening, you can see where the winds are coming in from the south, and that's why we're so hot and humid out there. And then north of the stationary front, temperatures are actually much cooler. But as we show you right now, temps in the 70s, as well as really near 80 degrees. And then we show you the afternoon. Look at these numbers out there, climbing to 95 for Atlanta, 94 for Savannah. You get some of these storms out there, you'll see a little bit of that brief cool down. That'll be some welcome news for you. But the problem is, it's going to feel like 105 when you add in the humidity. Now, as we show you for today, there is some relief in sight once we finally get this ridge broken down, get this dip in the jet stream. That's going to cool us off across parts of the southeast. At the same time, the West Coast, they are going to be sizzling there with temperatures well into the triple digits. For Charlotte, North Carolina, another day for 100-degree weather today, tomorrow, then we cool off for the weekend. And right now, Sam, we'll send it back over to you.
All right, Jen. And National Weather Service, Jim, out of Louisville, just saying that they're watching that rain move to the north, too. They just put out a statement that said folks north of I-64 may see some spectacular shelf clouds, but you may still not get some rain out of it. Brush fires and lots of them. We're going to tackle those fires in the west.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Beach Boys.
Critics are calling Love and Mercy the best musical biopic in decades.
I got different stuff inside me.
A triumph. Paul Dano and John Cusack are superb as Brian Wilson.
You think we could get a horse in here?
Love and Mercy, rated PG-13.
Lazy Boy Furniture Gallery's Red, White, and Blue Sale with 4th of July savings on recliners, sofas, sectionals, and more. Save on great American comfort and value. Hurry, these savings won't last long. Lazy Boy Furniture Galleries. Live life comfortably.
What are you doing?
I'm having a small snack.
What?
Have you tried this mayonnaise? It's great.
Gross.
Don't live with ants. Get Raid Ant and Road Spray.
Raid?
And take back your home. Raid kills bugs dead.
SC Johnson, a family company.
Monday on Altered Course.
I don't care who you put in our way. We're going to take him down.
It's go time.
I don't think anybody can outrun us, outtrain us.
It's do or die.
Come on.
Oh, my God.
Altered Course Montego Bay, Monday at 9 p.m. Eastern on Golf Channel.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. today, cloudy skies early, then partly cloudy this afternoon. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Tonight, partly cloudy skies. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
New episodes of Fat Guys in the Woods, Sundays at 9 on the Weather Channel.
AutoZone matched Jen with a new pair of Duralast wipers to cut through the rain. You call them wipers, she calls them blades. Where there are blades, there are ninjas. It's called The Zone, and we'll help get you there.
Hurry into Lowe's and find big summer savings for this 4th of July. Like 5 bags of premium mulch for only $10. Plus, now choose from 3 Spectracide triazicide insect killers for just $5.88. Don't miss out on summer's best savings at Lowe's.
Did you know only 1% of supplements have earned the USP mark? An independent certification for quality and purity. I recommend Nature Made because they've earned the most of any brand.
Nature Made, the number one pharmacist recommended letter vitamin brand.
Working on my feet all day gave me pain here.
In my knees.
But now I step on this machine and get my number, which matches my Dr. Scholl's custom fit orthotic inserts. Now I get immediate relief from my foot pain.
My knee pain.
Find a machine at drscholls.com.
10 minutes after the hour, and here we go, West Coast. 5 major wildfires currently burning in California, hundreds in Alaska. The largest, this one, the wildfire burning in the San Bernardino National Forest. That's east of LA. Scorched more than 20,000 acres. 2,000 firefighters and 100 fire engines are currently battling this blaze. It's threatening about 500 homes and structures there. It's only 33% contained this morning. Another wildfire, this one northeast of LA, drove about 1,000 people from their homes last night. NBC's Joe Fryer is covering that fire in Newhall, California, near Santa Clarita, right, Joe?
Yeah, that's right, Sam. You know, this fire came dangerously close to some homes within a few feet. The good news, the fire is now nearly 50% contained. All the evacuation orders have been lifted, so people are returning home. But this is a reminder, in California this year, the fire conditions are the worst on record.
This morning, firefighters in Santa Clarita are still working to contain a fast-moving brush fire that quickly scorched up to 350 acres Wednesday, threatening homes and causing evacuations about 30 miles north of Los Angeles. At the height of the fire, more than 500 homes were evacuated.
We're just in a defensive mode to defend the structures and not get perimeter control because it's spreading and it's not a contiguous line. It's a bunch of fingers with a lot of different heads.
Crews were relying on water-dropping helicopters and retardant-dropping aircraft to battle the flames. No injuries were reported, but investigators are on the scene trying to figure out just what caused the fire. And while firefighters in California are busy battling the worst conditions on record, in Denver, a rush hour storm dumped hail and up to 2 inches of rain, uprooting trees and causing widespread flooding that stranded residents.
This water was so high you couldn't even, the firemen had to come save me and it was up to here on my pants, so it was one of those days.
Because I thought we were going to drown, actually. I thought it was going to come in my house, actually. And I had to put my kids on their bunk bed with the floats. That's how scared I was.
Back here in California, we have seen nearly 2,500 fires already this year. That is well above average for this time of year. In fact, the 5-year average is more like 1,600. And this fire season is just getting started, Sam.
Yeah, hey, Joe, I'm just really curious. When you're walking around, I'm guessing that every branch, every limb, every bit of grass just feels dry and ready to go. Is that the case?
Yeah, I mean, we're 4 years into drought here, so everything is very dry right now. There's been very little rain. Here in Santa Clarita, there are certainly some dry areas. I was at the fire near Big Bear a few days ago, and that is just parched wildlands up in the mountains. It's just ready to burn, and it's a very dangerous situation because all it takes is a little shift of the wind, and a different area can go up in flames.
And all that will move fast. All right, NBC's Joe Fryer in Newhall, California this morning. Joe, glad you're there. I'm sure we'll be coming to you a lot in the future with what's about to happen there. Jen, this is that California situation just will go that quickly.
Right. And you know, and then the bad part is the temperatures are going to be soaring across parts of the Pacific Northwest and West Coast. And in fact, we already have excessive heat watch going in effect for Seattle. And we show you right now 64 degrees, really nothing happening out there. It's really quiet and dry. As we show you those temperatures for today, they're going to be 86 degrees. So touch warm outside. And then as we go through the weekend on Saturday, look at that, 91 degrees. Your average should be 72. And I know you're thinking, well, oh, that doesn't sound so bad. But the problem is some of these people out here do not have air conditioning systems. So this makes it even harder on the system. As we show you, this big ridge, it continues to build. And it's going to be building to the north. And it's not just going to be Washington as well as Oregon. We're going to see this across areas like Idaho, Boise, and Missoula. 15 to 30 degree temperatures above average for this time of the year. This is really insane. The problem is, it's going to last for potentially through next Friday. You see the numbers there. Hopefully, you are being safe out there. We're going to talk more about the severe weather threat coming up right here on AMHQ.
Hurry into Lowe's and find big summer savings for this 4th of July, like 10% off all in-stock deck boards. Plus, get a Kingsford 2-pack of charcoal for only $9.88. Don't miss out on summer's best savings at Lowe's.
Listen up, team. I brought in some protein to help rearrange the fridge and get us energized.
I'm new Ensure Active High Protein. I help you recharge with nutritious energy and strength to keep you active.
Come on, Fair. It's only a half gallon.
I'll take that.
Yay! New Ensure Active High Protein. 16 grams of protein and 23 vitamins and minerals. All in 160 calories. Ensure. Take life in.
Every backyard comes together around a grill and Kingsford charcoal. Gather round.
Everyone loves lazy summer days, but exciting summer days are even better.
During the Ready Set Summer Sales Event, get a 5-year warranty or save up to $1,000.
Working on my feet all day gave me pain here
in my lower back.
But now I step on this machine and get my number, which matches my Dr. Scholl's custom fit orthotic inserts. Now I get immediate relief from my foot pain.
My lower back pain. Find a machine at drscholls.com.
For those who can't imagine life without two wheels, Allstate offers a genuine parts guarantee that promises to fix your bike with original parts. Talk to an Allstate agent about all the things they do to keep riders riding.
Monday on Altered Course.
I don't care who you put in our way, we're going to take them down.
It's go time.
I don't think anybody can outrun us, outtrain us.
It's do or die.
Come on.
Yes. Oh, my God.
Altered Course Montego Bay, Monday at 9 p.m. Eastern on Golf Channel.
This Wednesday through Sunday at Tire Kingdom. Buy two tires, get two tires free instantly when you purchase our value installation package. Choose from select in-stock Goodyear, Continental, Cooper, Nitto, and more. We're kicking off summer with 5 days of savings. Buy two tires, get two tires free instantly this Wednesday through Sunday only, and only at Tire Kingdom Service Centers. That's all you need.
Brought to you by Infiniti, luxury cars that deliver inspired performance. Visit your local West Palm Beach retailer today.
New episodes of Fat Guys in the Woods, Sundays at 9 on the Weather Channel.
Stay tuned for your local on the 8s, brought to you by the all-new Fiat 500X crossover.
Amore.
Subito.
The all-new Fiat 500X crossover, featuring an available Uconnect system with a 6.5-inch touchscreen and available all-wheel drive. Well-rounded, has never looked so sharp.
Currently in our area, 85 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, sun and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Welcome back to AMHQ. Some ugly-looking skies in Odin, Indiana this morning. And you can see we clearly have a shelf cloud on our hands right through. And not only just one shelf, but sometimes you get several shelves. If you kind of look up above this, you see another laminated area of a kind of a differentiating cloud color, if you will, kind of a lighter gray. But let's take a look at this on radar, because we can actually see these on radar, and it's just incredible. Some certainly look better than others, but this one's really cool. So there's Odin. The reflectivity, of course, highest to the west, because we know the shelf cloud typically precedes the precipitation. That's what's going on in through here. But let's go ahead and look at this in 3D. So Odin's going to be, as we mentioned, in the area of low reflectivity. But if you look up above Odin, there is clearly that shelf cloud. And there it is right there, showing up kind of ahead of the main rain. And notice, even on this one, I think it's really cool. Remember I showed you kind of the different colors and the different layers? Mm-hmm. That even shows up on the 3D.
Awesome.
How sick is that?
Yeah, you can see the bumps and everything.
So
the
Brandon, darker, tilt this up a little bit. Because I want everybody to see kind of it's a show. You know, you can see how this is just overhanging right in through here. Then, of course, the precip's back here and the higher reflectivity. But even the different layers
of the shelf
cloud showing up there. So that is absolutely awesome. Unfortunately, typically with that, you are going to get some wind and some rain. And we may see this in Louisville pretty soon. You may see a shelf cloud or a roll cloud. But I don't think we're going to see any rain with it, because all the rain is going to be off to the northeast. All right. So sometimes you can get the rain cooled outflow, but not the precip. And in Louisville's case here today, that is the case.
Yeah.
All right.
Cool stuff. Fantastically cool stuff. All right.
Let's talk. I think I go right into my segment.
Oh, go ahead.
I was so excited about the shelf cloud.
I was like, let's just end it right there.
That's ending a positive note. All right. So, Brandon, tilt this up a little bit, because I can actually show everybody what I was talking about with Louisville. And you can see what we're talking about. I get a little carried away here sometimes, guys. Forgive me for getting carried away over the weather. You see that little gray line right there? That's the rain cooled air right there. The little cloud that's developed out ahead of that shelf or roll. We'll have to obviously add it to see it to look at it. But of course, it kind of attaches itself up into the rain here. But notice the rain's going to miss Louisville to the north, come through Frankfort. It's already in Carrollton, Cincinnati, I-75, crushed as all this will move across. You look at Carrollton getting absolutely hammered in through here. So get ready. And there's a higher definition radar of this. And you can see what is the shelf cloud now coming through Sellersburg, Goshen. You'll probably notice some cooler temperatures, and your winds will shift from southeast to northwest, more than likely, as this moves through. All right, our severe weather threat extending all the way over into Virginia, North Carolina today. Worried about this area because we've got maximum heating going on. It's going to be very, very hot, very, very humid atmosphere going on. Plus all that energy that's in Kentucky and Ohio is going to move off toward the east. So the models take that and really explode it this afternoon and this evening. Stormy weather for D.C. And also, again, because this is a high-resolution model, you can see little signatures on here that suggest damaging wind threats for southeast Virginia and north-central North Carolina. So we We have to watch that. Raleigh, Richmond, Norfolk, you are all in this for this afternoon and early tonight. Now I'm ready to pass it over
to Sam. All right, that's perfect, Jim Cantore. Stay with us all day long. Yeah, but Jim, are you sure?
No, but I will.
You can go longer.
I will,
all right.
Okay.
All right, Jim had some incredible pictures. Ari's in for anaritis, so let's see if you can top them.
Well, I don't know if I can top that. Well, you know what, maybe we'll just give it a whirl. We've got a really nice sunrise this morning. This is in Mountain Home, Idaho. Okay, look at the color of that.
It looks
like a little tail just kind of floating
just
up there in the sky.
Beautiful.
And they're getting ready for the heat. Huh?
Yes, exactly. There you go. Oh, it's going to be brutal up there, guys. I mean, we're complaining about down here, but geez, that west heat wave is going to be bad. All right, let's take a look at a picture from Florida. Composition here.
Nice.
Beautiful, but so dangerous. Yesterday, I was going to go hit golf balls after work. I saw a big rain shaft over 285, and then I saw a cloud-to-ground lightning strike, which, by the way, was not even really all that close to where the precipitation was. So, very, very dangerous stuff. All right, one more. This is an awesome sunrise. You be the judge. I mean, I think the 3D radar, man.
Beautiful.
Look, these are technically...
like a fishing pole.
Yeah, right?
Photo.
Awesome stuff. This is also from Florida. These are technically called crepuscular rays. It's just a big word for sun rays. Pretty cool stuff, right?
Wait, can you spell that? Use it in a sentence?
I'd have to look down. C-R-E-P-U-S-C-U-L-A-R.
All right. Not bad, not bad at all.
We'll be right back.
Bill, have you seen my keys anywhere?
I'll help you look. Maybe you left them in the bathroom again.
Warning signs of Alzheimer's disease may be right in front of you.
It's all right, baby.
For help and information, call the Alzheimer's Association or visit alz.org/10signs.
Deep in the dark, untouched recesses of your engine is power you never knew it could produce. And vapor can set it free. New Stable 360 Performance unleashes that exclusive vapor technology that rises above the fuel line to protect your engine where other additives can't. To help keep your engine running cleaner, leaner, smoother, and stronger than ever. The next level of performance is in the vapor. Stable 360 Performance.
Minions, rated PG. Are you still getting heartburn flare-ups? Time for a new routine. Try Nexium 24 Hour, the latest choice for frequent heartburn. Get complete protection. Nexium Level Protection.
When you have a migraine, you'll reach for anything to make the pain go away. Truth is, most pain relievers don't work like Excedrin Migraine. It relieves my pain starting in 30 minutes. That's fast, plus sensitivity to light and sound.
Excedrin Migraine.
Wow, that was fast.
Hurry into Lowe's and find big summer savings for this 4th of July, like 25% off select patio collections. Plus, get a $100 gift card on all Charbroil grill purchases, $3.29 and more via mail-in rebate. Don't miss out on summer's best savings at Lowe's.
Now everyone who uses catheters can get a better catheter with Liberator Medical's free catheter sample pack. These new catheters are better than ever. Easier to use, more convenient, comfortable, virtually pain-free. Don't wait. Call now and get your free catheter sample pack. There's the all-new compact catheter for women. Pre-lubricated, no drips, no mess. Fits in your purse. The self-lubricated catheter. It lubricates itself in the package. Comfortable, no mess. The closed system catheter, pre-lubricated with its own collection bag, proven to reduce UTIs. The discreet pocket catheter, curved to fit in your pocket to go anywhere. The polished eyelet catheter for micro-smooth comfort, reduces friction and pain. Call now. We'll also bill Medicare and your insurance for you. Call for your free catheter sample pack with free shipping. Call Liberator Medical.
Call 1-800-601-3450. That's 1-800-601-3450.
Sunday, on an all-new episode of Fat Guys in the Woods.
For these three radio DJs, this is a nightmare.
What are we gonna do for food?
I mean, that's what we're doing, man. It's real simple. Kill it and eat it.
A new episode of Fat Guys in the Woods, Sunday at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 85 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. today, sun and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Weather Channel's most watched original program,
and it just hit us,
is back.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
Twenty-nine minutes after the hour. Glad you're with us now. Watch this. Watch the plant stand go. You're looking at video of an EF1 tornado in Portland, Michigan. Tree goes. Now, if you look very carefully, you're going to see that tree come right back across like that fast. Winds up to 100 miles an hour. Took out some homes and businesses there. Welcome back to AMHQ. We've got the video to slow down to show you what you're actually seeing in that, and it's pretty impressive.
Right, and right off the bat, I want to make this observation. It's already raining.
Yeah.
So you can't see the tornado, all right? But you got to trust that it's in there. And now you know why when you see the tree. But what's cool, I mean, this tornado literally went right over this area. So the tree blows left first, and then as the tornado goes past, you get the switch, and that's two frames, by the way. We could only slow it down. There's one here, when we circle it. There's the first frame when it starts to come back. And look at how far it goes how fast are these frames, guys? The speed is
There's just a few of them. Just a few of them. And then it's right out.
So 30 frames a second. So the tree snaps off, and that doesn't get blown over. It snaps. You can see the bottom of the tree here. Mm-hmm. Just snap. There it goes that way. Tornado comes over. Everything reverses. There goes the tree.
Right. Looks like we almost put it in reverse, really. Right.
So that's why we need you to trust these tornado warnings. You would not have seen that.
And it
would have been in your house or in your window.
That exact tornado, the one in Portland, Michigan, that trapped Jenny Reed and her two children, one just 1 year old, the other one about 2.5, inside a Goodwill store. We talked to her about what that was like early this morning.
Was walking around, so I grabbed him and put him by my legs between the cart and me. And then my one-year-old was sitting in the cart in the little baby seat, and so I leaned over my youngest, so I kind of tried to cover both of them. I was standing the whole time, and the roof almost went. It landed around us, basically. I don't understand how it happened, but it happened that way, and we got very, very lucky.
Very lucky. Her instincts were to protect her children, so she grabbed one, put him under the cart, leaned over the other one that's in the cart. The windows had already blown out in front of her, and then the roof fell down on top of them. So that's...
She went into mama bear mode.
Barely a scratch. Barely a scratch.
So glad to hear they're okay.
Such good news.
Mom of the year right there.
All right. And hey, we've got big changes coming, right?
Yeah, we do. We have some big changes coming, especially for the Northeast, as Jim is just kind of illustrating over there. What comes up must come down. Right.
Trough ridge.
It's just like, you know, when you go to the park, you probably haven't been to the park in a long time, Sam.
What?
But
I'm actually more interested in where she was going with that.
Me too. Why would you say
Where are you going with that?
Of course I am.
You're a little too grown up to go to the park, okay?
I mean,
you're
not going to. I'm too old?
No.
Is that what you're saying?
Wow.
I need a walker.
You're going to the pool. You're not going to go hang out and ride on the swings or things like that. Right. But what we're going to be looking at is a big swing in the temperatures. I'm not trying to offend you. I swear I'm not. I hear you two over there. We have three views this morning. Pittsburgh, New York, and Boston. You just need to buy me a shovel, Jim Cantore, so I can just dig myself out of my trouble. As we move ahead and we talk about for the forecast for the Northeast, Boston, you're going to be actually 10 degrees below average for this upcoming weekend. Yeah, you heard me right. I said it correctly. For Boston, Saturday, 68 degrees, cloudy skies out there. And here comes Saturday. Look at the big drop in the temperature, 59 degrees. We got a low that's developing. It's coming through. And once we get that to the north, you get in that warm sector, your temperatures rebound on Sunday with a high of 70 degrees. But while the numbers, okay, you're fine with that. But the problem is we're going to be looking at some rain. Here comes this low developing the Appalachians. As it comes through, it's going to be pulling in that moisture. In some of these locations, they're going to be picking up up more than 2 inches of rainfall. We'll see it for Saturday. You're looking at Pittsburgh, Philadelphia, Washington, D.C., thunderstorms in the forecast, even into Saturday night. And with that low, we're also going to be looking at some of those strong winds as it makes its way up towards the east. And then Sunday, still holding on to that rainfall across parts of New England, where actually they're dealing with a moderate drought out there. And, you know, I guess we need to check to see what the updated information coming out of the drought monitor today. But as we show you for Saturday, New York, 70 degrees, rain out there, thunderstorms on Saturday night, and the same for Sunday. So kind of a crummy weekend. You're going to be like, wait a minute, is this like early spring when it's actually full on summer?
Yeah. Let me grab my teeth and out of the bowl, and then
and
you can lead me
park.
To the park. Yeah. All right. Let's check in with the top news stories of the day. Ari's in for Anna Ritas. Good morning, Ari.
Hey, good morning, guys. We're going to start you off in Massachusetts, where the Boston Marathon bomber, Johar Tsarnaev, apologized to his victims and their families. Now, Tsarnaev admitted his guilt before a federal judge formally sentenced him to death. An F-16 fighter jet crashed in the Arizona desert during a training exercise. Now, as of yet, officials have not released the status of the pilots, but reports say that the crash ruptured a gas pipeline and ignited a huge fire. And another shark attack along the North Carolina coast. Police say an 8-year-old boy has superficial wounds from an apparent shark bite. And just 2 weeks ago, two swimmers lost limbs to sharks off North Carolina. Okay, here's kind of a cool story. How about this? Detroit Tigers, Miguel Cabrera, you know him? He actually made a new pal during Tuesday night's game against the Cleveland Indians. So this young Indians fan, he caught the foul ball in his cap, and then he shouted, "I got your back." Okay, so Cabrera then gave him his batting gloves, a bat, and two baseballs. So how's that? Some good sportsmanship there. Man, there have been
very cute.
A lot of people making good catches in the audience lately.
Everybody holding a baby, you know?
Yeah, man. How about that?
That was nice, Ari. That was nice. Hey, let's get into this parts of the country, the heat, the baking heat and record-breaking temperatures. Millions of people are searching for ways to beat the heat. We're going to help you this morning because CNET senior editor Dan Ackerman is with us this morning with some tech tools to help you stay cool. Hey, Dan, good morning. How are you?
Hey, Sam, I'm doing good. And you know what? The first thing I want to tell you about is actually a Kickstarter product that's crowdfunded. It's a smart water bottle. It's called the Hydrate, and they use an I instead of a Y in it. And it's got a sensor in it. It can tell how much water you consume. But then that talks to an app that's on your phone. It's an activity tracker. And the two of them put their data together and say, you've been doing too much, you know, motion, activity, working out. You need to drink more water. The bottle glows and tells you to drink more water.
You know, it was one of our three things. We like to find three cool things to talk about every day, Dan. That was not too long ago. All right, so it's a cool idea. Now, people take their e-readers with them on trips, but I've never been able to use it by the pool or in bright sunlight, any of those things. Now there's a new one that's fixed some of that, right?
Yeah, I mean, if you're going to go outside by the beach, by the pool, you want to read something, your smartphone, your tablet, it's going to be pretty useless because the screens just wash out in the sun. E-ink readers like the Kindle Paperwhite, and there's a brand new Kindle Paperwhite out just this week. It's got a higher resolution. It's got a new font on it. These actually work in the sun, and that's what makes them so great. And they're pretty inexpensive. It's about $120, and like you know, an iPad is obviously like $400 or $500. And if you're going to take one of these, or like, you know, even if you have your iPad or your phone, you want to keep it safe, you could buy like an $80 or $90 waterproof case for it. I'll tell you what, just put in a Ziploc bag. If you drop it in the water for a minute, you'll be able to rescue it. It's going to be okay.
You may notice that all of us have done that in hurricane coverage or storm coverage on the Weather Channel. Truly, Ziploc bags, everything inside, electronics inside, and you can still work them. It's a little hairy to work them in the rain, but it works. All right, now, what I'm looking for, and help me if you can, Dan, something that'll chill my drink when I'm at the beach.
Oh, man. I'll tell you, this is one of my favorite examples of kind of low-tech, high-tech. I've used this a long time. It's called the Cooper Cooler. And I actually have my personal one right here. You plug this in, you put ice in it, and then the top opens up. You can put in a soda can, a beer bottle, a bottle of wine, a bottle of champagne. There's different programs for every size drink, and you press the button on here, and it spins the bottle in the ice for about 4 minutes, brings it down about 30 or 40 degrees. It's shocking how quickly it works, and then you have an ice-cold drink right there on your patio, on your porch. You can plug it into an inverter in your car. You know, it's a great example of gadgets, gear that's not super, super high tech, but does a great job.
Genius. Genius, Dan Ackerman. We thank you for being with us. Senior editor for CNET this morning. We thank you very much, sir. Hey, allergy tracker, just a quick look because tree pollen is going full blown in some areas. So we're going to show you quickly what's going on. And you'll notice the red that's going on in Michigan and the UP, but actually some of the worst cities for tree pollen today, Eugene, Oregon, Salem, Oregon, Portland, Oregon. And though it's not showing up in the bright red there, I'm going to tell you it's probably because these trees are facing some heat and everything's getting ready to go right there. Allergy tracker, by the way, just go to weather.com/allergy.
Currently in our area, 86 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, sun and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Flonase Allergy Relief Nasal Spray. 24-hour relief that outperforms a leading allergy pill. Most allergy pills only control one inflammatory substance. Flonase controls six. Seize the day and the night. New Flonase. Six is greater than one. This changes everything.
Did you know that meeting your daily protein needs actually helps to support your muscle health? Boost High Protein Nutritional Drink can help you get the protein you need. Each serving has 15 grams of protein to help maintain muscle, plus 26 vitamins and minerals, including calcium and vitamin D, to support strong bones. Boost High Protein is the number one selling high-protein complete nutritional drink, and it has a great taste, guaranteed. Help get the nutrition you need every day with Boost High Protein. Join the club at brandpower.com.
What are you doing?
I'm having a small snack.
What?
Have you tried this mayonnaise? It's great.
Gross.
Don't live with ants. Get Raid Ant and Roach Spray.
Raid?
And take back your home. Raid kills bugs dead.
SC Johnson, a family company.
Every backyard comes together around a grill and Kingsford charcoal. Gather round.
Let's do this. Don't think it's possible? Think again. With the summer's best savings, the upgrades are better than ever. So let's go for the bells and the whistles. Fridges that open like this. And whoa, did you see that? It's time to reset our expectations. Right now, it's all within reach. Let's do this. Get a Samsung washer, dryer, or fridge, each just $9.98. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
It can be hotter than Death Valley in your attic.
Take these boxes. They're not only perfect for storing old yearbooks and pictures, they're also a perfect food source and nesting material for roaches.
That's why I use the latest scientific methods. Orkin. Pest control down to a science.
Fact. Advil is not only strong, it's gentle on your body too. No wonder doctors and patients have trusted Advil for their tough pains for over 30 years. Relief doesn't get any better than this. Advil.
There's a more enjoyable way to get your fiber. Try Philips Fiber Good Gummies Plus Energy Support. It's a new fiber supplement that helps support regularity and includes B vitamins to help convert food to energy.
These are good. Nice work, Philips.
The tasty side of fiber from Philips.
This moment of independence brought to you by your U.S. Army.
Need new tires? Right now at Pep Boys, when you get three Falcon, Cooper, or Hankook tires, you get the fourth tire free instantly. Plus, get no interest and paid in full within 6 months on your Pep Boys credit card. Trust the boys to get you there.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Beach Boys.
Critics are calling Love and Mercy the best musical biopic in decades.
I got different stuff inside me.
Extraordinary, exhilarating, a triumph.
You think we could get a horse in here?
Love and Mercy, rated PG-13, now playing.
Make the cash call and ask for the do-over refi. If you refinanced your mortgage in the last 18 months, we can redo it at a lower rate, like today's 2.99% rate and APR, with no closing costs. Just call 855-890-CASH.
43 minutes past the hour on AMHQ. We're in Northern California. Massive brush fire. Look at the fire just burning there. It burned more than 500 acres, prompting 30 homes that had to be evacuated. Now, luckily, now the fire has been fully contained. This is in the area of Antioch, California. Officials are still trying to determine where the fire started. As you said, you can see it being fanned out there. Luckily, there were no injuries reported with this.
When you looked at that, it looked like it was just being pushed by like a downdraft. The Cal Grove fire scorching more than 350 acres. We're talking about that in Southern California. About 45% contained there. California Highway Patrol is now saying people can get back into their homes. They're even escorting them back in, lifting that mandatory evacuation. But let's get into our Eyes on the West Coast. Crystal Egger, good morning, Crystal, from KNBC. Hey, Crystal, so here we start now with these fires. We got a lot of them to talk about.
I know. Sam, as you know, I grew up here in Southern California. I remember after a long, hot summer, we would get into fire season. Here we are. We're just starting summer, and we have a lot of fires burning deep into this drought. It's not going to take a lot for a fire to start or for a fire to spread quickly. We've talked about this a lot right here on AMHQ. We aren't even in a Santa Ana event, but these onshore winds are really fanning the flames in the afternoon, and they're not even that strong. So right now, what you're seeing is the Cal Grove fire, our latest fire, which started yesterday afternoon. The good news is that we are at 60% containment right now. We have crews out there, and we were just updated by firefighters. Evacuations have been lifted. Sam, we need rain more than ever. We have a chance of dry lightning this weekend, which is not great, but hopefully some wetting rains following that from some of the thunderstorms.
Yeah, Crystal, thank you so much for spending a second with us. I hate to hear that the onshore winds are also moving those fires around. Normally it's the warmer, drier western wind. So Crystal Egger, and if you're in LA, watch her on KNBC. All right, here we go with the Michelin Road Report, sir.
Yeah, really. I mean, when you think about summer driving, you know, you run into wet at times, sometimes downpours like we've been having in the United States. But really, whether you're driving a minivan or a Beamer, the tire makes all the difference in the world.
All right.
Check it out.
All right, Eddie, what's our next test?
We're going to do a tire comparison out here on our wet handling course. We've got a BMW and a minivan. Which one do you think is going to be faster?
Easy, the Beamer.
Well, let's go find out.
All right.
Here we've got a three-gate slalom. This would be like swerving through, you know, to avoid traffic or something like that. Looking at grip, stability, how confident you feel in the vehicle.
Here's the deal. I'm in a minivan. I probably just wouldn't even drive this fast because it's a big vehicle. But now that I've gone around it once and I can feel the way the tires are, I feel a little bit more confident. I can't believe I'm driving this fast. I'm driving a minivan like a performance vehicle.
And you're having fun. I see a spark showing up.
Is that what it is, a spark?
Yeah.
I just drove that minivan like it was a race car. How do we do that?
Well, it doesn't make you a race car driver.
No, no, it doesn't. That's unbelievable. Don't try that at home, but I can't believe the handling I got with this thing.
It's
That's
very
amazing.
Impressive.
Must have something to do with the tires. I don't know. We'll see.
This car's a basket case to drive right now, right?
Yes.
So this is, of course, nothing against BMW. You just got a budget set of replacement tires. And you can see how drastic of an effect it has on the vehicle.
I mean, dude, I got no control on the vehicle.
Yeah.
And I'm not even half the speed as I was going with the van. This is unbelievable. I mean,
there we go.
Look at that.
There we go. Crazy, right?
Stalled it out. It's all about the tires, man. It's all about the tires. I had no control of the vehicle. And I didn't even push it like I pushed the minivan.
And you're not going to get to learn this lesson out on the street until it's already too late.
Thanks, Ed, man. Great lesson learned
today.
It's
a pleasure.
Great lesson learned. Woo! Sweating watching that.
You have got to tell people they were not bare tires.
No, those were not bare tires. First of all, I have a Beamer, and they drive great. I've been, you know, to performance driving classes as well. But this was just a set of tires you would go buy
at any store. You know, it's a very cheap set of tires. The Michelin tires that we used were obviously a performance tire. And driving that minivan, I had all the control over the world. So trust me, the tires matter.
We saw you taking out that cone.
I took out a few cones. That's only the ones we could put in the package.
And off-roading, and nose in the cone with the front of the car all the way down.
The Beamer was brown.
Brought to you by Michelin, a better way forward.
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tires she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even as it wears down over time, its safety doesn't, thanks to Evergrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn.
In a matter of seconds, your life can change.
We're kids still in school.
And it just hit us.
This was it.
The Weather Channel's most watched original program is back.
Things are just going everywhere.
Was it a nightmare?
And then it was silent.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
Currently in our area, 86 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, sun and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
To Lowe's and find big summer savings for this 4th of July. Like $10 off our best interior paint and primer in one, and up to $25 off all resurfacers. Plus, get 20% off all in-stock level or faux wood blinds.
Working on my feet all day gave me pain here.
In my knees.
But now, I step on this machine and get my number, which matches my Dr. Scholl's custom fit orthotic inserts. Now I get immediate relief from my foot pain.
My knee pain.
Find a machine at drscholls.com.
Andrew, Rita, Sandy, meet Chris, Jackie, Joe. Minor damage or major disaster, when you need us most, we're there. State Farm, we're a force of nature too.
Amore.
Subito.
No!
Ooh. The all-new Fiat 500X crossover, featuring an available Uconnect system with a 6.5-inch touchscreen and available all-wheel drive. Well-rounded, has never looked so sharp.
To a new home, now there's a simple way to transfer your Xfinity service. Through the Xfinity Movers Edge program, you may be able to relocate your existing Xfinity equipment or have a self-installation kit sent to your new address. Install the Xfinity equipment in your new home yourself or get professional installation scheduled on the date you choose and within a guaranteed 2-hour appointment window. Moving has never been easier when you call the Xfinity Movers Edge hotline at 1-855-MOV-EDGE.
summer's on us at BevSmith Kia. For a limited time only, get 0% financing for up to 66 months. Plus, we'll cover your first three payments. New 2016 Sorentos, zero down, $299 a month. New Optimas, zero down, $279 a month. Plus, they're backed by our low price or it's free guarantee and free tires and batteries for life. It's the Kia Summer's on Us sales event going on now at BevSmith Kia, saving you the most on the Treasure Coast.
Hey.
The Weather Channel's most watched original program.
And it just hit us.
Is back.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
It has been a wild morning across the Corn Belt. We've seen some pretty heavy rain in spots. We've also seen some interesting cloud pictures as well. And a lot of these heavy rain showers have been preceded by what we call a shelf cloud. So time lapse here out of Bloomington, Indiana. You can see it. You can't see the shelf because of the way the camera's tilted here. But that's probably a shelf cloud that precedes the rain. In this case, the shelf cloud preceded the rain. But in this case, I'm going to show you on the air right now, there's a shelf cloud, but there's no rain. All right, and that can happen. Sometimes that cold air, which is more dense, comes out so far ahead of the actual rain, the rain sometimes can just dissipate or go off in another direction. And that's what's happened in Louisville this morning. I've just gotten some tremendous pictures from you guys in Louisville. First of all, you'll kind of notice something right in through here, and that's the leading edge of the rain cooled air, and that's essentially the leading edge of the shelf cloud. So let's take a look at this in three dimensions, because it's really awesome when you tilt it down. So here we are, we're kind of looking from the top down. Brendan, let's go down and we can show everybody where Louisville is. There it is right there. You remember that little line that I showed you right in through here? So this is the leading edge of that rain cooled air. So remember, that thunderstorm or that rain off to the north has pushed all this cold air out. Cold air being more dense is going to sink, and what happens with the shelf cloud is it actually just lifts the warm air over the top of it, and you get this little stable layer cloud, we call a shelf cloud, that precedes it. And they can look really awesome, like what we've seen this morning out of some of these pictures. So as we kind of go up and down and top, you can see it's very, very thin. It's not very deep at all, maybe a few hundred feet to 1,000 feet in this case. And of course, the rain is all the way back to the northwest. So you get to enjoy the shelf cloud and the beauty and not the rain, at least this time in Louisville. All right, let's take you in and talk about what's going on right now with the current rain, because many areas are getting it. Cincinnati, some pretty heavy rain. Independence, I told you I-75 was going to be a miserable drive, and there it is right there. Rain on the doorstep to Lexington. You will probably get not only a shelf cloud in Lexington, but also the rain coming up in through here as all this pushes on off toward the south and east. And all this is going to progress across West Virginia, across Ohio today, and make its way into parts of Virginia and also North Carolina this afternoon. And some of the models, especially the high-resolution models, even though our Torcon numbers aren't that high, are suggesting some damaging wind, okay? This is the HER model, and it goes out for about 15 hours, but that's really crunch time. We see some isolated storms develop, okay, as we work our way through the 6 o'clock hour. We'll have to watch these. Could have some hail, could have some microbursts, some very, very gusty winds, but then a little bit more organization as we get into the evening, and some of these suggest potential wind damage. So Raleigh, Richmond, Norfolk, all of this pushing on off to the southeast as we go through these evening hours, entirely possible. Expect some delays later on this afternoon around Washington, D.C. The big story that will unfold over the next several days here is the threat for very heavy rainfall. All right, very heavy rainfall over the next 72 hours. Sam, we'll talk about that a little bit later on. Back to you.
Jim, everything you just showed about the line of shelf clouds, Ari has a perfect example in a real picture.
Yeah, Jim was talking about the pictures of it, and it's kind of blowing up on social media right now. I mean, a lot of shelf clouds showing up because it's a big city. We've got Louisville, and the shelf cloud itself is really quite spectacular. Okay, this is just one example. I mean, you can probably just go on Twitter, search for Louisville, search for shelf cloud. You're going to see a lot of pictures like this from a lot of different angles, from a lot of different distances. I guess we got another one now. Check this out.
Oh, holy moly, I love that.
Wow, how about that?
Racetrack.
This is actually in Kentucky. But, same type of deal there. Same stuff Jim was showing. You could see that little thin band on the radar. And in a lot of cases here, there's not even much rain behind it. In Louisville, you're not going to get rain behind that. It's just going to be a good gust. Other spots, you will get a little bit of rain behind it. But really cool pictures this morning, and that's what's going on right now. Okay, so we got to plug a little bit of a contest that we're doing on weather.com. It's actually really cool. This is not just some, you know, lame-o raffle or something. We're actually going to pay people for awesome your pictures are, right? So, I mean, we love to get your pictures. We literally couldn't do it without you. I mean, it's the pictures that tell the story. So, now is your chance to get some cash. Weather.com is launching the It's Amazing Out There photo contest. So, one lucky winner will get $15,000. 15 G's, all right? That's a lot of money. Runners-up get cash prizes, too. So, you know, everybody's got a chance at least. And, of course, we want your, I want to know which camera I'm on. Hey, there we go. We want there your we adventure pictures and, of course, the incredible images of nature. And you've got until, I believe it's July 16th. So check it out. Weather.com/photos.
Make that
really
money.
Easy to do.
Yeah, although we're not past a lame-o raffle, this is not
right,
bad.
That's
okay,
right.
Let's,
we may have
you,
one
let's
of
show
still.
You one thing quickly. I want to show you the lightning in Cincinnati all the way moving Carrollton right now. It's on its way to Maysville. So northern Kentucky, you're definitely getting into some of this. Frankfort, you're going to miss a lot of it. It's going to pass just to your north. But I will tell you that in that line, we've had more than 200 lightning strikes in just the last 15 minutes. We'll continue our coverage of this line of storm and the big heat moving across the country on Weather Center Live. Jen Carfagno and Maria La Rosa up next. Have an amazing day.
Bye.
Currently in our area, 86 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, sun and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Weather Center Live. I'm meteorologist Jen Carfagno.
And I'm meteorologist Maria La Rosa. Severe storms, flash flooding, we're in for another round today as storms will stretch across multiple states.
You know, more than 40 million people are in the red zone today. We could see severe storms, tracking them today and tonight, and it includes the risk of strong winds, the risk of large hail, and potential tornadoes. So we'll break down the timing and the threats as we head in through the afternoon and evening.
And how about this? Lightning myths debunked. Lightning also a major threat today. We're going to debunk some of the popular myths about taking cover from the dangerous lightning bolts and how you can get struck even when the skies are clear.
And speaking of storms, we have seen some tremendous video of the power of thunderstorms, including strong winds, even tornadoes. We're going to show you some of the most amazing images from the last couple of days of powerful storms.
And taking a live look at Washington, D.C. right now, already 80 degrees as we take a look at the White House. Partly cloudy skies for now, but a chance of thunderstorms as we get in through the later part of the day. And Jen, we're not talking about just plain old thunderstorms. These could get nasty.
Yeah, they all lately seem to pack a punch, don't they? We've got some this morning that we've been tracking out there with at least a lot of thunder and lightning. So some loud storms this morning. Now, right now, the cluster we've been tracking is right over southwestern Ohio, northern Kentucky, Louisville. You're getting quite the show off to your north right now in Cincinnati. It is overhead. So here's a look at the radar. Where we see the yellows on the radar, that indicates where some heaviest of rain is falling right now from Dayton down towards Cincy. The red is the heaviest rain, and down 71 right now, you're getting clocked with some big rain as well as a lot of thunder and lightning out there. Could be some gusty winds out ahead of that as well. So let's look at what's going on in the big picture. You know, we've been tracking this big cluster of thunderstorms since the overnight, and you saw that big cluster, that nocturnal cluster of thunderstorms, which is typical with the situation we got going on here. And it's sort of spread out a little bit, and it's continuing to move along, though, and it's tracking right along this boundary. That's what you often see, is these clusters develop overnight. They track along the boundary. Now, it is a warm front, so we'll have to see if this warm front starts lifting a bit, and that could actually move the where we see the thunderstorms later today. Let's track it for you. We've got our jet stream winds here paralleling the front. You know, when things are sort of lined up like this, it tells us the main risk is going to be damaging winds. There could be some hail, though, and there is an isolated tornado risk across this area, too. We got some Torcons out there. A 3 in northeastern Missouri. Again, it's right along this boundary we'll be watching today. It is a 3 as well in southwestern Ohio, and a 3 in the mid-Atlantic as well, as we track the Delmarva, eastern Virginia, a 3 on the Torcon. So we'll track these storms, and in about a half an hour, I'll show you the timing of how these storms are going to progress eastward today. Maria.
Yeah, and timing is everything, Jen. Take a look at this. This is a time lapse of storms rolling into the Denver area yesterday evening. Marble-sized hail was reported in downtown Denver just as the workday let out, and minutes after the hail started, tornado sirens actually sounded in the city. As of right now, there is no confirmed tornado in the area, but as you might imagine, with clouds looking like that, people took shelter immediately. But there was certainly plenty of flooding on the streets, too. Check it out. Several roads and intersections in and around the Denver area look like rivers. Look at that. Denver police reported several vehicles stuck in floodwaters, as a matter of fact. And you can see just how swiftly it is moving, and got up to the wheel wells pretty easily there with some of those parked cars. So dangerous situation there. And once again, we find ourselves in the plains, the front range, looking at the potential for severe weather. But take a look at all that played out yesterday just in the Denver metro area. Everywhere you see a blue circle is a storm report. And this one happens to be the wind damage, with significant damage to large trees with a few toppled over this east of Denver. And then you have here to the south side, hail about an inch and a half in diameter in Denver. Keep in mind, too, the airport located east of downtown, so you're like right in this area, but we had a lot of heavy rain in the immediate metro, somewhere around an inch and a half to almost 2 inches of rainfall. So any showers or thunderstorms that pop up today have the power of putting down more hail and more rain, of course, more wind damage. This is the risk area today. You see from Casper, south of Rapid City, Cheyenne, and Denver. But I want you to look outside this area, too, because this time of year, with these kinds of conditions, yes, even general showers and thunderstorms could easily put down a little bit of hail and certainly gusty winds, but may not officially be severe, and certainly could wreak havoc on travel at the airport in Denver along I-70. You see by this afternoon, there you go, along I-25, and then boom, 76 and I-80. Showers and thunderstorms really beginning to pop up here. And Jen, as we've seen, very easily could be producing damaging winds.
And, you know, I'm sure we're going to get some video out of it like we've seen all week. We've had such an incredible week of thunderstorms. So let's take a minute and look at some of it. We want to start with the tornado that hit in Portland, Michigan. We've got some new surveillance video available now of some damage being done. So first of all, you see the wind and the rain and everything moving around. Keep watch here at the top. We want to see what happens as this wind continues to blow through. You see debris and this tree just gets completely taken out. Now we're going to show it again so you can watch what happens. The wind starts to pick up. You can see the wind blowing the rain along. You start to see pieces of debris, some tree limbs, some trees. Oh, and that tree just goes down completely uprooted. One more time, we're going to put a spotlight on it. You can see where it ends up, right over here. So the tree begins here, gets blown completely off its roots and out over the sidewalk or ground. All right, let's take a look at some other scenes from this week. We've had a lot of these clouds lately, right? Roll clouds. This is an awesome view at sunset on Fire Island, New York. This was just as the storms were rolling in here on Tuesday. So let's see, we'll play it again. You can take a look here. Some of the cumulus clouds here building off in the distance, but then watch this form right here. Nice roll cloud as you nice formation right there as you see this in time lapse. Very cool video, Fire Island, New York here. What a sunset view we had that night, by the way, too. And there was Little Mammatis at the beginning of that, in case you saw it there. All right, one more. And we've got, speaking of Mammatis, we've got some amazing video from Mike Seidel.
There it is again.
There we go.
I guess he's gonna give it to us.
We got back to the roll. That's it. That video didn't roll, but But why not? Why not still look at this roll cloud? That's pretty cool. All right, here we go. Oh, gorgeous. A rainbow coming out of the anvil of a thunderstorm. And you can see the Mammatus as well. I love Mammatus clouds. We've had so many great pictures of them this week, Maria. And just tremendous with that rainbow, too.
Yeah, there's just something about the shape of them and the way it catches the light there. They're photographed beautifully. But that's an amazing shot right there. Let's get back to lightning. Does lightning really strike twice? Can rubber shoes really protect you? Coming up, debunking some lightning myths.
Every backyard comes together around a grill and Kingsford charcoal. Gather round.
Hurry into Lowe's and find big summer savings for this 4th of July. Like 5 bags of premium mulch for only $10. Plus, now choose from 3 Spectracide triazicide insect killers for just $5.88. Don't miss out on summer's best savings at Lowe's.
When you're waiting for summer, every second feels like an eternity. So when it finally arrives, make every second count on a Sea-Doo watercraft. With 14 models to choose from and starting at just $49.99, there's a Sea-Doo that's right for you. At the Countdown to Summer sales event, get up to a 5-year warranty or save up to $1,000. But hurry, this offer ends May 31st. Go to Sea-Doo.com or your local dealer for details.
Fact: when pharmacists are in pain, the medicine in Advil is their number one choice for pain relief. More than the medicines in Tylenol or Aleve. Use the medicine that pharmacists use most for themselves. Relief doesn't get any better than this. Advil.
Hey, you working for Nature Made too?
Yup.
Go team!
You've heard about friendly probiotics, but why take one that only targets half your digestive tract? New Nature Made Advanced has dual strains that target your whole tract. That's friendly. New Advanced Probiotic from Nature Made.
Time to sweat, boys. Big time.
Let's get this thing right.
I have made fire!
New episodes of Fat Guys in the Woods, Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 86 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, sun and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Weather Channel's most watched original program,
and it just hit us,
is back.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
Let's do this. Don't think it's possible? Think again. With the summer's best savings, the upgrades are better than ever. So let's go for the bells and the whistles. Bridges that open like this. And, whoa, did you see that? It's time to reset our expectations. Right now, it's all within reach. Let's do this. Get a Samsung washer, dryer, or fridge, each just $9.98. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
When you have a migraine, you'll reach for anything to make the pain go away. Truth is, most pain relievers don't work like Excedrin Migraine. It relieves my pain starting in 30 minutes. That's fast. Plus sensitivity to light and sound.
Excedrin Migraine.
Wow, that was fast.
What are you doing?
I'm having a small snack.
What?
Have you tried this mayonnaise? It's great.
Gross.
Don't live with ants. Get Raid Ant and Roach Spray.
Raid?
And take back your home. Raid kills bugs dead.
SC Johnson, a family company.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, there it is.
again.
I don't think it's going to give it to us, guys. Oh, as soon as I say that, I hope you enjoy it as much as I do.
Oh, this is Hunter Lee Reeves giving us his reaction of, oh, yeah, to the lightning around Parsons, Tennessee. I love this, Maria. This is fantastic. I think this is close to a Chris Young song. Oh, nah, is how the song goes. But you can make it into a song. I love it.
We were playing it yesterday and thinking that he's the Jim Cantore Thunder Snow of lightning.
Exactly. Exactly.
Oh, yeah.
All right, we all get excited when we see lightning, right? But we get frightened, too, as we should. And this week is the National Weather Service's Lightning Safety Awareness Week. Yeah, there's a lot of myths and just some outdated practices, actually, when it comes to safely taking cover.
And our severe weather expert, Dr. Greg Forbes, breaks down what's fact and what's fiction.
I want to talk to you about some lightning myths. One of those is that if you're caught outdoors, you can get some measure of protection by crouching down. Now, that lightning crouch involves at most a minimal amount of safety. If the lightning is coming down at a diagonal, maybe it will miss you if you get yourself 2 feet lower, but it's going to strike the ground nearby. You'll probably get hit anyway. You need to be seeking shelter, avoiding being outdoors in those activities, going to some metal top vehicle or some permanent building. And golf gets a bad reputation. It's not just golf, of course, that's dangerous, but it's other things like fishing and boating and any kind of sport activity that puts you outdoors with no safe place to go that can allow you to get hit. Now, here's some other myths. One is that wearing rubber shoes or rubber tires of a car or bicycle rubber tires will protect you. It's not any of those. If you're in a car, it's the metal body that will conduct the electricity around you. So that's the fact. It's not rubber at all. That is just not true. Lightning can't strike twice. That's certainly false. It often hits mountains and tall buildings. In fact, in a year, the Empire State Building gets hit about 100 times, maybe even 12 times in an individual thunderstorm. And then one more, lightning victims are not electrically charged after they have been struck. So you should apply CPR. You should apply life-saving techniques to try to save them. Back to you.
Hi, Dr. Forbes, thank you. We want to show you some amazing video of lightning from Rosemary Beach taken Tuesday night. This is a beach here in the Florida Panhandle, one of the South Walton County beaches. Look at that, Maria.
Do they call that spider lightning? Because it's like crawling across the sky. It is a spectacular display.
You see a lot of detail, right? You see all the sort of the step leader, and you see all the sort of almost see the dart leader.
Yeah.
Oftentimes, you don't get to see a lot of these details unless you're looking at lightning in slow motion.
That, and you get that expansive view on a beach like
well,
that.
Well, that's true.
You get great viewing conditions.
Well, speaking of slow motion, the National Weather Service has a lot of great information out there, especially for this week, Lightning Safety Awareness Week, and some incredible images and videos.
Yeah, we got some great slow motion images on their webpage. And like you said, it's something amazing seeing the process
right
of
here,
lightning.
Yeah. I mean, when you slow it down, like in this case right here, you can really see all the details of what's happening, especially watch this. You see the step leaders coming out, and then in this figure number three, you really see how bright that return flash is.
What I think is so fascinating about this is you do see the process where it's crawling down, but you see it trying to meet up as well, and it tries to find that connection.
Yes, find that connection. And I learned after rereading all of this is that lightning can't see all the way to the ground, right? So it's sort of like every 50 meters, it's looking for the best path. That's why it looks so fragged like that.
And that's the key, too. It's finding the path of least resistance, really.
Right. Yes.
And it may be the tallest object. Oftentimes it is, but not necessarily every single time. And that's kind of one of those hidden dangers of lightning. You think you might be okay if you're not next to a tall object.
Well, coming up later in the show, we've got Jim Cantore in the lab to show us some very incredible images and an exceptional way of explaining the anatomy of lightning.
How it forms, where it forms, why it forms in a way, of course, only Jim Cantore can do.
Into Lowe's and find big summer savings for this 4th of July, like 10% off all in-stock deck boards. Plus, get a Kingsford 2-pack of charcoal for only $9.88. Don't miss out on summer's best savings at Lowe's.
You ever feel like you're spinning?
Like you're stuck in the same place in life? Just going round and round and round? Yeah, man. Been there.
No, actually spinning.
Oh, we can fix that by going to Midas. They have a great selection of tires. Sorry, Doug, I thought you were trying to get deep.
It's time to take a closer look at your tires. Get up to $140 back by mail on a set of four Goodyear, Cooper, and other select brands. Tires, brakes, oil, everything. Trust the Midas touch.
Our eyes, they have a 200-degree range of sight, which is good for me. Hey! And bad for the Barclay twins.
Take care of all your most important parts with Centrum. Now with our most vitamin D3 ever.
Great suckers. Your car insurance goes up because of their bad driving. People try all sorts of ways to get rid of them. If you're sick of paying more than your fair share, get Snapshot from Progressive and see just how much your good driving could save you.
Sunday on an all-new episode of Fat Guys in the Woods.
For these three radio DJs, this is a nightmare.
What are we going to do for food?
I mean, that's what we're doing, man. It's real simple. Kill it and eat it.
A new episode of Fat Guys in the Woods, Sunday at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
So you take a chance on that slick DirecTV offer. $19, you think. But after just 3 months, you're paying over $100 a month, and it keeps going up. Suddenly, you're locked into a 2-year contract that could cost you nearly $3,000. Thinking about DirecTV? Better hang on to your wallet.
Don't fall for DirecTV's latest offer. There's nothing direct about DirecTV.
Maxwell's is now open in the Driftwood Plaza of Jupiter. Gold, silver, coins, diamonds, jewelry, paintings, and objects of art. If you don't want it or wear it, sell it to Maxwell's. We buy and sell diamonds of all sizes, clarity, and condition up to 10 carats in size and above. We have decades of experience buying and selling gold, coins, diamonds, and objects of art. Maxwell's, located in the Driftwood Plaza on US 1 in Jupiter, Florida.
The Weather Channel's most watched original program,
and it just hit us,
is back.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
Stay tuned for your local in the 8s, brought to you by the all-new Fiat 500X crossover.
Amore.
Subito.
No!
The all-new Fiat 500X crossover. With 70 standard and available safety features, including options like all-wheel drive and blind spot monitoring, it's eye candy that watches the road.
Currently in our area, 88 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, sun and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Moments for people who saw a tree fall right in front of their car. This was in Sewell, New Jersey on Tuesday. The woman credits her brother for staying calm, getting them out of there and saving their lives. Winds hit 85 miles per hour. The National Weather Service says there was no evidence of a tornado touching down. It said the damage was consistent with straight line winds. And Jen, another demonstration how you don't necessarily need a tornado to do some major damage.
Oh, for sure. Marie, I'm sure you read about some of the conspiracy theories out there now. People are upset that the Weather Service didn't call it a tornado. When you see damage like that, you sort of want that bragging right, right, that it was a tornado. But damaging winds can do just as much. And you saw that in the case there with those severe thunderstorm winds knocking down the tree. Now, today we've been watching thunderstorms here. Some gusty winds. Looks like the storms are below severe limits now, but we still have a lot of thunder and lightning out there and a lot of heavy rain as well, and probably some gusty winds that we're tracking here as we continue to watch active weather from Cincy down into northern Kentucky. We zoom on in and you can see we've got the storms rolling right through Cincinnati. They're continuing on the move here, now moving east of I-75. Nonetheless, here they're moving pretty fast. We do have some heavy rain coming down with them when they're right overhead. That's going to be another hazard that you're dealing with. Also, traveling on I-70 and really I-75 north of Cincinnati, you are in some very steady, and it's moving along, but you still got at least another half hour or so in the heaviest of the rain. Maria.
Well, Jen, that severe weather threat will be in Ohio today. We want to talk about what's expected and all the factors going into how it will play out. Brandon Pelequin from the National Weather Service in Wilmington, Ohio, which serves the Cincinnati metro area. Thank you so much for taking time with us today, Brandon. We know that the thunderstorms have gone through this morning, but we're looking ahead to how that may play a role or not play a role in how the severe threat will play out later this afternoon. What are you all seeing?
Well, you're right. One complex of showers and thunderstorms has been moving through this morning. Probably going to be some rain through lunchtime or so, and then a break during the early to mid-afternoon. Now, the big question is how much can we destabilize and recover later on this afternoon? If we can get some destabilization later on in the afternoon, then there could be some thunderstorms, say after 4 or 5 p.m. right into the evening hours.
Since you guys had this heavy rain this morning, Brandon, do you think this will create a bigger flash flood risk later today with heavy rain potential?
Well, we've received some quite a bit of rain over the last few days, some more rain this morning. So if you add another inch or two of rain later on this afternoon, this evening, there certainly could be some flood issues.
You know, we've been seeing a lot of wind damage from thunderstorms with these complexes that have come on through. Have you heard any reports so far of any of the ones that have come through already this morning?
From the thunderstorms this morning, we don't have any reports of damage. Now, the Cincinnati area did receive a wind gust about 40 miles an hour, but all the storms this morning were sub-severe.
What about the tornado risk for today?
Well, again, this hinges on the amount of destabilization we can get in the afternoon. If we don't destabilize very much, showers and thunderstorms would primarily have a risk for heavy rainfall and some strong winds. But if we get a little more destabilization, especially, say, south of the Ohio River, then there could be an isolated tornado in any severe thunderstorms that are able to form.
All right, Brandon Pelequin from the National Weather Service in Wilmington, Ohio. Appreciate the time. And it was a rough morning drive for the Cincinnati area. Yeah. It could be again this for the evening rush.
The evening commute, too. All right, short work day for some of you. Going in late, maybe leaving early might be the best thing to do. Coming up, we've got more on today's severe weather threat and our other top story, which is the heat.
Brutal heat wave, in fact, that could shatter records in the West. When will normal temps return? Our inside weather discussion with WSI's Dan Leonard next.
Hey, Hunter, need some pointers?
Just around the house.
Yeah, it should do it then.
I love this free store pickup.
Yeah, it's also great when you're on tour. Just order online, we'll have it waiting for you the same day. You know, I bet there's an ace within a golf swing at just about anywhere.
Really?
Oh, you don't need to...
New mailboxes.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Getting help at Ace is like going to your neighbor.
Drive safely, Hunter.
Thanks again, Mike.
Every backyard comes together around a grill and Kingsford charcoal. Gather round.
Did you know that meeting your daily protein needs actually helps to support your muscle health? Boost High Protein Nutritional Drink can help you get the protein you need. Each serving has 15 grams of protein to help maintain muscle, plus 26 vitamins and minerals, including calcium and vitamin D, to support strong bones. Boost High Protein is the number one selling high protein complete nutritional drink, and it has a great taste, guaranteed. Help get the nutrition you need every day with Boost High Protein. Join the club at brandpower.com.
At last,
Sometimes at last doesn't happen at first.
My love has come along. My lonely days.
Your dad just kissed my mom.
Are over.
Turning two worlds into one takes love.
And life is like a song.
Helping protect that world takes State Farm.
It may seem strange, but people really can love their laxative, especially when it's Miralax. It hydrates, eases, and softens to unblock your system naturally, so you have peace of mind from start to finish. Love your laxative, Miralax.
I'm only in my 60s. I've got a nice long life ahead, big plans. So when I found out Medicare doesn't pay all my medical expenses, I got a Medicare supplement insurance plan.
If you're eligible for Medicare, you may know it only covers about 80% of your Part B medical expenses. The rest is up to you. Call now and find out about an AARP Medicare Supplement Insurance Plan insured by United Healthcare Insurance Company. Like all standardized Medicare Supplement Insurance Plans, it could save you in out-of-pocket medical costs. Call now to request your free decision guide.
I've been with my doctor for 12 years. Now I know I'll be able to stick with them.
You'll be able to visit any doctor or hospital that accepts Medicare patients. Plus, there are no networks and virtually no referrals needed. See why millions of people have already enrolled in the only Medicare supplement insurance plans endorsed by AARP. Don't wait. Call now.
Time to sweat, boys. Big time.
Let's get this thing right.
Episodes of Fat Guys in the Woods, Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 88 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, sun and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Channel's most watched original program,
and it just hit us,
is back.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
Is absolutely beautiful, but also very, very dangerous. Yeah. Yes, it is Lightning Safety Awareness Week. We appreciate you staying with us for Weather Center Live. I'm meteorologist Maria LaRosa.
And I'm Jen Carfagno. And we're going to break down what causes those spectacular images in just a few minutes. But first, let's take a look at a few cities that will see some lightning today, along with, of course, the rain and maybe a bit of wind out there. We're looking at a couple spots in the Midwest, Maria.
Yeah, we've got St. Louis looking, you know, kind of dark right now onto the left, and then Indianapolis on the right. What a morning you've gone through with the heavy rain that is pushed on now. And then DC on the bottom there, just primed and ready for some rough weather later on this evening, Jen.
Yes, so we're going to track that for you actually into DC and show you the timing of when storms will come through. Let's look at right now. We've got the rain out there on the radar in Ohio down into northern Kentucky. That's the biggest problem spot. We're going to be watching for, you know, this big cluster of storms that we've been tracking all night long. It's been weakening. It's shrinking in size here, and that's some good news certainly for anyone downstream of this. But we'll keep watching it because we think things could still refire later today. Now, where the cluster of storms has been tracking has been right along our boundary. Very typical of the summertime. You get these big overnight clusters of storms. They track right along a boundary. In this case, it's a warm front. So we're going to watch it wave a little bit farther north today, and that will adjust where those storms do track. Things are lining up when it comes to the front, when it comes to the jet stream energy, and really when it comes to the mid-level jet as well. So with that kind of situation, you'd expect the risk for some severe weather, but you'd expect damaging winds to be the main risk. There is an isolated tornado risk, though, and we got some torcons of 3 in that red zone as well today. All right, so let's time things out. And so this is the forecast mode here. We're going to be watching for some showers and storms getting into western Pennsylvania a little bit after lunchtime. Pittsburgh heads up about 1, 2 o'clock today. And then we track additional storms firing in eastern and central parts of Kentucky into West Virginia. And then watch here on the other side of the Appalachians. Just after the dinner hour or around the dinner hour, storms start to refire and moving through the D.C. area. By the time you get to 10 o'clock, things are better for you in D.C., but not necessarily down towards Norfolk and out into the Delmarva area. Watching for some pretty potent storms, we think, by later today. Some gusty winds, potentially damaging winds are possible with those. D.C., we timed things out for you. Some showers in the forecast for the commute home and thunderstorms possible even into the late hours tonight. Maria.
And potent is a good word, too, to use in the plains today. We have that area that could be looking at some rough weather, and we've seen it, right? Just in the Denver area alone, you see all those circles there. Those are storm reports that have come into the Weather Channel. And you can see in Aurora, significant damage to large trees with a few toppled onto streets in the 23rd and Galena vicinity. And a lot of heavy rain, but you've seen some hail pile up, too. This one reports hail up to 1.5 inches in diameter. That's just south of town. And that heavy rain, 2+ inches in some of these spots. Also keep in mind, you've got a lot of major interstates. You've got the airport east of town. So when you look at this graphic here, there's Denver. The airport's right about there. So we may expect to see some delays here, weather-related, by the afternoon, but includes Alliance into Wyoming, Cheyenne as well. Primary threat, as we've seen, the damaging winds and large hail, along with the heavy rain. Let's time it out for you. Keep an eye on the clock. You've got I-70 here. Here's I-80. And then you see the showers and thunderstorms. Storms explode there by later on this evening, right along I-80 and pushing off to the south. Jen?
All right, well, let's talk about heat. We're going to keep tracking it westbound here. In Portland, Oregon, looking out the window right now, temperatures in the 60s, a gorgeous blue sky. And you're saying, what's wrong with our weather? Nothing. It's perfect. Well, it's about to get very hot and stay hot for days. And that's the story in the West, is this long heat wave we are expecting. Portland, just one of the cities. In fact, here, pretty much everyone is going to feel the effects of the heat. We've got a lot of watches and advisories up already. Excessive heat watch includes Portland and Seattle, but a heat advisory in effect for Spokane and Medford and down towards Winnemucca in Nevada. Big area of high pressure, big ridge of high pressure here, very strong, and it's going to be expanding as we get through the weekend. So what we expect to see is temperatures going above average. It's going to stay above average throughout this area. It's going to stay dry as well, and one often feeds into the other. So hot and dry is the story for you starting this weekend and then continuing pretty much for the rest of the month. We've got temperatures running 15 to 30 degrees above average, 108 in Medford, Spokane going up to 97, even into Montana and down into Utah and certainly across a lot of Idaho. We are going to feel this heat, a string of days hitting 90 in Seattle. You know, Sunday getting very close to 90, but there's a chance we get there. Portland 91, Medford 102, and likely to set a record string of 100 plus days for June in Medford.
And those overnight temperatures, the lows are going to be 10, 15 degrees above average too. Mm-hmm. So the trend is there, but we want to go further inside weather here on this heat with WSI senior meteorologist Dan Leonard. Dan, always great to talk to you. We're seeing these conditions. We know the area is primed for fires, and we're seeing them happen right now in Southern California. So what are you seeing here for the next few days for this area? Because, boy, we could use some rain.
Yeah, you just saw Jen's graphic. I mean, we don't really have a lot of relief in sight, right? That big upper level ridge builds out of the southwest, crests up into the northwest, and you're talking hot, dry weather. I wouldn't be surprised if we rival some of all-time June records for some of the northwestern cities. I know Medford is vulnerable, Boise probably vulnerable over the next couple of days. This is a really impressive heat ridge, and unfortunately, I don't really see it going anywhere anytime soon. In fact, a lot of the data that I look at suggests this could become a semi-permanent feature this summer. So next week and beyond, probably right through at least the first couple of weeks of July, this ridge will set up right on the coast. So that means more hot, dry weather, not just for California, but also the Pacific Northwest. fast as well.
Okay, that's crazy. A permanent feature for the summer. That's big, Dan. You know, in the West, we've been talking a lot about the ridiculously resilient ridge, as it's been nicknamed, and, you know, especially with California and their drought. What does this mean for the drought for the rest of the West, too?
Well, obviously, it's not good, right? A ridge, you don't want a big ridge on the West Coast if we're going to try to cure this drought. Obviously, you don't get a lot of rain typically in the summer along the coastline. That tends to move up more in the inland areas with the monsoon. But we could use at least a little bit to get some shower and thunderstorm activity in there, at least relieve things a little bit. But that's also another point to look at, is when we get these monsoonal type flows that come in out of the Southwest, a lot of times you can get shower and thunderstorm activity. And when you have very dry, low level conditions like this, a lot of the thunderstorms are high based. So you tend to get a lot of lightning and the rain tends to dry up as it comes down. So that's not a good thing, because that lightning can bad sign if we start to get into a monsoonal flow with very dry low levels. We could see an increase in fire activity, especially across the Northwest over the next few weeks, I think.
And real quickly, you know, you hear semi-permanent feature here, and it would be hard to imagine something unlocking that kind of pattern. What would it take? Would we see, you know, El Nino relax? Would that take it?
Well, yeah, that would be one way to do it, right? Unfortunately, that's not going to happen. El Nino is here to stay. It's here to stay this summer, probably right into the fall and winter. But the good news is that El Nino does correspond to stormier and wetter and cooler than normal temperatures in the fall and winter. So if we can last that long, then, yeah, we'll start to get some relief for California and the interior areas of the West. But until then, I just don't see any relief. The El Nino in the summertime tends to correspond to big ridging on the West Coast. That's what we have right now. That's what we'll have next week and probably through the rest of the summer.
Wow. All right, Dan, thank you. Next hour, we'll talk more about the heat and then the wildfire risk, because we're already getting a very busy start to the wildfire season in California, in the Northwest, and also in Alaska, too. So we'll get to that.
All right, thank you, Dan. Another myth about lightning is that if you're only in danger if the storm is overhead.
Not so. Coming up, we're going to show you the bolt from the blue phenomenon and how lightning can strike miles away.
Currently in our area, 89 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, sun and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Pressed soap, homemade hot sauce, artisanal pickles, whatever those are. Well, we're glad Handcrafted is finally cool, because at Firestone Complete Auto Care, we've been handcrafting since 1926. Robots might build cars, but it takes human hands to keep them running right. And that's a guarantee, backed by our fixed right promise. Firestone Complete Auto Care. Whatever you drive, drive a Firestone.
Firestone Complete Auto Care. Maintenance, repairs, tires. Whatever you drive, drive a Firestone.
The Off-Outdoor Refresher Course. Gatherings. Extended family, meet crowded living space. Claustrophobia, meet phytophobia. It's time to unlearn your fear. Step 1, open door. Step 2, light off mosquito lamp. It protects an area up to 10 times larger than the leading citronella candle. Step 3, enjoy the air. Between you and the in-laws, get back out there with off mosquito lamp. Keep bugs off.
SC Johnson, a family company.
Before space stations, before moonwalks, we lit that candle and shot to the stars. Walk among our most powerful creations at the Rocket Garden, one of thousands of exciting things to explore at Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex in Orlando. Always exploring.
Welcome to the sleep revolution. All new Emergen Z, a natural way to power down with melatonin plus vitamin C and other antioxidants to work their magic while you sleep. Don't just sleep, revitalize. New Emergen Z, power down to power up.
Before fingerhut.com, my budget used to keep me up at night.
How are you going to pay for the kid's new Dell laptop for school? And the missus wants a KitchenAid mixer for her birthday. And...
Hey, you're forgetting about fingerhut.com.
We can shop over 275,000 items and growing with brand names like Black & Decker, Reebok, and Dyson. At fingerhut.com, you can get the credit you deserve. And with their low monthly payments, we can all rest easy.
My seafood like I like my vacations. Tropical. And during Red Lobster's Island Escape, three new dishes take me straight to the islands. Like the ultimate island seafood feast with crab, lobster, and jumbo shrimp. All you have to do, get here while you still can.
Let's do this. Let's go for the bells and whistles. With the summer's best savings, it's all within reach. Let's do this. Get a Samsung washer, dryer, or fridge, just $9.98. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
If you have moderate to severe plaque psoriasis, isn't it time to let the real you shine through? Introducing Otezla, apremilast. Otezla is not an injection or a cream. It's a pill that treats plaque psoriasis differently. Some people who took Otezla saw 75% clearer skin after 4 months. And Otezla's prescribing information has no requirement for routine lab monitoring. Don't take Otezla if you are allergic to any of its ingredients. Otezla may increase the risk of depression. Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Side effects may include diarrhea, nausea, upper respiratory tract infection, and headache. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you're pregnant or planning to be. Ask your doctor about Otezla today. Otezla. Show more of you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Beach Boys.
Critics are calling Love and Mercy the best musical biopic in decades.
I got different stuff inside me.
A triumph. Paul Dano and John Cusack are superb as Brian Wilson.
You think we could get a horse in here?
Love and Mercy, rated PG-13.
Bill, have you seen my keys anywhere?
I'll help you look. Maybe you left them in the bathroom again.
Warning signs of Alzheimer's disease may be right in front of you.
It's all right, baby.
For help and information, call the Alzheimer's Association or visit alz.org/10signs.
It is Lightning Safety Awareness Week, and we've been talking all things lightning. You know, often though, I think people think that they can't get struck unless it's raining, and that is so not the case.
And it's not even the case with the clouds overhead, because right. We know that even with the sun shining over us, one, it can rain. We've seen that before,
yes, but also yes. You
can get struck by lightning.
You can, and it happens, and it all, you know, surprises people as you would expect here. It's something called a bolt from the blue. I mean, when you've got storm clouds overhead, you get nervous about the weather, right? But if you're standing out in blue sky, Maria, there is still a chance if there are storms in the vicinity that you could get struck.
Well, think about how long a lightning bolt looks to you from far away. Well, it can stretch out from the parent storm just as far. Mm-hmm. So we're talking miles and miles and miles. So if you've got blue skies over you, Jen, and the lightning strikes, just like
there
that.
There you go. That was some good aim. It could strike as far as 10 miles away from the thunderstorm, 15 miles, and I saw that NASA actually measured one time more than 60 miles away.
It is just unbelievable. So lightning is fascinating. It's fascinating to us. It's a very dangerous component of severe weather, of course. So how does lightning occur? We want to show you something amazing using 3D graphics you'll only see here at the Weather Channel. Jim Cantore explains the anatomy of lightning.
Talking about something that strikes the Earth 25 million times a year. And remember, the bolts that strike the Earth are only a quarter of the percent of all the lightning. In other words, 75% of the action actually happens in the cloud. So let's talk about the anatomy of a lightning strike. Rising air, it's an awesome thing. Clouds develop. You get condensation, you get precipitation that develops within the cloud, either as raindrops, soft hail, grapple, and all of these things, especially the ice crystals, have charge. And when they're up there 40,000, 50,000 feet, you've got a nice positively charged cloud top. But at the base, your ions are negatively charged. And if you've ever held two magnets together, you know what happens when you have the opposing charges. They just kind of come together. Well, something like that happens in the cloud, where all of a sudden those negative ions are going down to meet the positive ions that are on the ground. So let's go down toward the ground and talk about some of these things that are all positively charged. Essentially, you know, the charges follow the thunderstorm around, both in the cloud and also on the ground. So here comes this thunderstorm moving over you. Your whole area here on the ground is positively charged. You've got rooftops. You've got telephone poles. You've got mailboxes. You've got automobiles. And what happens before a lightning strike is these negative charges start to descend from the cloud, probably within the precipitation, the rain, and the hail shield. But at the same time, the positive charges also start to come up to meet them. So the step leader meets the up or the upward streamer, and boom, when you connect that channel, you get the lightning strike. And you're talking about anywhere from 250,000 or 250 million volts to a billion volts, depending on how much charge is actually in that channel. And until you completely discharge that channel, you will continue to see the flashes go on. So again, most of the lightning happens underneath the cloud, where we're actually getting the descending negative charges, meeting the positive charges. But Sam, every once in a while, you will get those charges that are outside the cloud. And it's still a little bit unknown as to what happens there, because you're taking a positively charged cloud top and meeting something that's positively charged on the bottom. But we know we can't do that, right, based on magnets. So something happens with the polarity. Something, you become all of a sudden negatively charged, and you become the outward channel. And if you're the highest object out there standing on the water with a fishing pole, it may be sunny. But remember, up in that cloud top, there's a lot of electricity and electric charge. And unfortunately, if you complete that circuit, you're going to get struck by lightning, even when the sun's out.
Great visualization of
yes,
what happens.
Yes, that was really awesome. So we'll talk more about lightning safety, of course, through the show today. Also coming up, why Hawaii needs to pay close attention to the tropics going into the 4th of July holiday.
Plus, strong thunderstorms new commute yesterday, turning streets into rivers. We have the latest coming up.
Hurry into Lowe's and find big summer savings for this 4th of July, like 25% off select patio collections. Plus, get a $100 gift card on all Charbroil grill purchases, $3.29 and more via mail-in rebate. Don't miss out on summer's best savings at Lowe's.
It may seem strange, but people really can love their laxative, especially when it's Miralax. It hydrates, eases, and softens to unblock your system naturally, so you have peace of mind from start to finish. Love your laxative. Miralax.
Every backyard comes together around a grill and Kingsford charcoal. Gather round.
In a matter of seconds, your life can change.
We're kids still in school.
And it just hit us.
This was it.
The Weather Channel's most watched original program is back.
Things are just going everywhere.
It was a nightmare.
And then it was silent.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
Currently in our area, 89 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, sun and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day.
Are you road ready? Underinflation gives tires better traction in warmer weather. True or false?
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tires she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even as it wears down over time, its safety doesn't, thanks to Evergrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn.
B, false. No matter the season, your tire's worst enemy is underinflation.
Take me in into your darkest hour, and I'll never desert you. I'll stand by you. Yeah!
Yeah. So that's our loyalty program. You're automatically enrolled, and the longer you stay, the more rewards you get.
Great.
Oh. I'll stand by you. Won't let nobody.
Isn't there a simpler way to explain the loyalty program?
Yes.
Standing by you from day one. Now that's progressive.
Listen up, team. I brought in some protein to help rearrange the fridge and get us energized.
I'm new in Sure Active High Protein. I help you recharge with nutritious energy and strength to keep you active.
Come on, pair. It's only a half gallon.
I'll take that.
Sure Active High Protein, 16 grams of protein and 23 vitamins and minerals, all in 160 calories. Ensure, take life in.
When you have a migraine, you'll reach for anything to make the pain go away. Truth is, most pain relievers don't work like Excedrin Migraine. It relieves my pain starting in 30 minutes. That's fast, plus sensitivity to light and sound.
Excedrin Migraine.
Wow, that was fast.
A witness when you set the world in motion. The Ram ProMaster van. And introducing the all-new Ram ProMaster City. Purpose-built to help you run the town. Ram.
So you take a chance on that slick DirecTV offer. $19, you think. But after just 3 months, you're paying over $100 a month, and it keeps going up. Suddenly, you're locked into a 2-year contract that could cost you nearly $3,000. Thinking about DirecTV? Better hang on to your wallet.
Don't fall for DirecTV's latest offer. There's nothing direct about DirecTV.
It begins with finding this hostel on Booking.com. Where you also find her. A romantic fumble at this romantic chateau leads to these fine humans, who you take to this eco-lodge to get seriously close to nature. Then you check in with her at this tropical paradise, before soaring over this castle resort with your father-in-law, who finally seems to like you. Life can be like that when you get it booking right. Booking.com, booking.yeah.
The Weather Channel's most watched original program.
And it just hit us.
Is back.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
All right, welcome back. I'm hurricane specialist Michael Lowry with a quick check of the tropics today. Looking across the Atlantic Ocean, hardly a cloud in the sky, a clustering of any clouds, all the way from the Gulf of Mexico to the eastern Atlantic. A lot of dry air out here in the eastern part of the Atlantic Ocean. Not expecting any development here over the next few days, but an area of the tropics that I do have my eye on is here in the Central Pacific Ocean, oddly enough. Over the next few weeks, warmer than average waters there have set up. We're in an El Nino year, so we already have the warm waters in place. What we haven't had across the Central Pacific, though, are the favorable upper level winds. Very strong jet stream flow across most of the Central Pacific right now. But as we move into the first week or two of July, we're going to get a high pressure set up at the upper part of the atmosphere, weakening those upper level winds. The surface pressures and the models are beginning to fall. So really, we're going to want to look out here in the direction of Hawaii come, say, the first week of July for possible development. Not seeing anything imminent in the models, ladies, but something certainly to keep an eye on, especially if you have plans to go out to Hawaii for the 4th of July week. Back to you.
All right. Michael, thank you for that. Let's talk about the weather we've been having in the southeast, how hot and humid and, oh, just muggy it has been lately. We're actually going to get a change. Right now, Atlanta, 82 degrees. Your dew point is up there, as it always is, in the upper 60s or at least close to 70. So when does that break? You might want to know. And some of you might think not till September. Actually, by this weekend. We got a break coming to the southeast from all of the humidity and the hot temperatures that we've seen lately. So what's been going on for us is that we've had this big Ridgener jet stream here across the east. That is actually going to dip down over the east as we get you into the weekend. And that's going to allow cooler air to come in, drier air to come in. That's going to make it more comfortable. It actually will also give us an uptick in some storm chances too, which will factor into the cooler temperatures. But this is key. So we watch these cold fronts that come through, swing through. We're going to be watching for disturbances that roll through. Yes, it will be stormier, but it will also be cooler when it comes to the temperatures. You know, today, tomorrow, we still got a lot of 90s out there, but by Saturday, 83 in Atlanta, 80 in Asheville, I should say, we are going below average through the southeast. D.C., New York, Pittsburgh, all going to feel it big time below average. Look at Pittsburgh, your high temperature, only 67 degrees. The south will feel some of that as well. And you'll really notice that I think the most when it comes to these dew points, Maria, dropping dew points into the 50s is something we haven't seen in a while, and it will feel very comfortable out there through the south and east.
I cannot wait. I'm marking my calendar right now at 6 p.m. on Sunday. Amazing. All right, talk about amazing. This is an amazing video from yesterday's storms in Colorado. This happens to be in Stapleton, Colorado. Just an absolutely incredible picture, a wonderful view of what a strong thunderstorm and the structure of that storm can look like. You have the lowering base, and it looks like, Jen, maybe even some of the anvil, and not quite Mammatus, but
it's trying.
Yeah, it's trying.
Very, very cool storm. All right. Cool to look at from this vantage point. And we've got some more video to show you as well with some time-lapse clouds over Colorado.
And Denver offers one of those, you know, landscapes that makes viewing these storms really spectacular. And Chris Sanchez doing this video for us here. And you can see almost sort of hovering over the same area as the storm develops. And you see the lowering cloud base there and just the inflow that's creating that.
This is very cool. Love to watch. You know, I love to watch clouds. It's because it shows you the air, right? The air is always moving, but we just can't see it moving. But we can see it when we get clouds.
And it's a great point. Time lapse allows us to see the fluidity. And speaking of fluid, you've got lots of it. Happened to be flooding in Cherry Creek Mall in Denver. This was shot by Twitter user Ultra5280. Literally coming through the lights and the roof. What a mess.
Wow, what a mess. It was a tough rush hour yesterday. A lot of flooding in the Denver area. We'll watch more storms again today. And we'll also talk about that risk of lightning.
And some myths, too. Along with the brutal heat wave, more than 40 million people under severe threat right now, too.
We'll be back in 60 seconds.
Currently in our area, 90 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, sun and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 77. Friday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.